lock it. So we live, Aqua.
Alright, Age on the wall, Machia. While Aqua, the elect of the nation of Israel, starting with 144,000 men. Hey, welcome back to another spiritual camp session. Today is Sunday, July, was it July 24th, right, brother? So today is Sunday, July 24th, the year of the turnip, the year of amplification, okay, 2022. So before we start this spiritual camp session in the spirit and power of the Heavenly Father and the Son, we turn to the east. We give all praises to
Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh, Hashem, HaKadosh.
Yahweh, that's the true name of the Heavenly Father. In the world, through ignorance, caused God, Jehovah, or Yahweh. Yahweh means He exists, and to be. Hashem, in the name of Yahweh Shai, to the world through ignorance caused Jesus Christ. Yahweh Shai means He saves, He delivers, and that's the Messiah of you so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans in these last days. Hey, in these last days, man, Yahweh Shai has brought forth, okay, the prophets of old, okay, back in the reincarnation to prophesy the downfall of this wicked kingdom. So in the spirit, we're going to start the book of double honor to the apostles of the water, the honor to the apostles and elders at Great Millstone. Move out and teach folks sound doctrine. The men that taught us 100% truth according to the scriptures. So let's start in Rack 17 in the Apocrypha, which is the Apocrypha, that's part of the King James Bible, the original 1611 letter. Right here, these King James 1611, right? This is the original Bible, okay, that you're supposed to read, okay, to understand, you know, the scriptures. So get that bro set rag on.
And the Apocrypha means what? Hidden away, right?
Yeah, that's where you get the word crypto. You know, like cryptocurrency, hidden money. And that goes into the hidden writings of Yahweh Shemel Shai, only given to a specific man in these last days.
Back in the days, we used to be called what, crypto Jews. Because our actual nationality, these different people within our queendoms were trying to, you know, take away our nationality, okay? So this is Sirach 17 and 5. It says, and they received the use of five operations, and Yahweh Shemashai in the sixth place, he imparted them understanding and the seventh speech.
And the spirit broke, because I believe is either Bruce Willis, he made a movie called The Sixth Sense. And there's a scene where, you know, you have this, I believe it's this kid, he's able to see spirits. He's able to see the left hand side. So that's an example of an extra operation that he was given. Now the only difference of in these last days of prophets, we have seven operations. Okay, the operation to you know, see both good and evil, but also seek the understanding of prophecy. Remember?
So it says, tell me when it's good.
It's got to scoot it back so they can see all of us.
Sirach 17 and 5. It says they received the use of five operations of Yahweh Shemashai in the sixth place he imparted them understanding in the seventh speech.
Yeah, understanding of what? Understanding of good and evil. It tells you that in the book of Job, real quick, we'll back you up. It says, giving them understanding. This is Job 28 and 28. And unto man, Yahweh Shemashai said, behold, the fear of the Lord, that is wisdom, and to depart from evil is understanding. So the only way to receive understanding is if a man departs from evil. What are some examples of evil? Anything that's contrary to the scriptures. You know, committing adultery, that's evil. Okay, eating abominable foods, that's evil. Okay, following the ways of a so-called white man, that's evil too, man.
This is Sirach 15:1, and it reads, he that feareth the Lord will do good, and he that hath knowledge of the law shall obtain her. As a mother, she shall meet him, and receive him as a wife married of a virgin. With the breath of understanding shall she feed him, and give him the water of wisdom to drink.
Good. And that's an example of the beginning of wisdom, is to fear Yahweh. Now, that's how you're able to receive the understanding of the law, the testimony, presented to Isaiah, the 8th chapter, the 20th verse. I want to back you up on that real quick, bro. This is Psalms 11 and 10. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. A good understanding, there you go again, the word understanding, have all they that do his commandments, his praise endureth forever. An example of doing the Lord's commandments is to come out here in the highways and hedges and prophesy the downfall of Esau, Edom.
And that's the Psalm of David, right?
Yep, the Psalm of David, yep.
And also, that's reiterated in the book of Proverbs, you know?
I think it's the third chapter.
This is Proverbs 1, you know, in Proverbs, yep. The book of Proverbs.
Yeah, Proverbs 1 and I think 7.
Yep.
So I'm right here. I can go to this. This is Proverbs. Yeah, that's just the beginning. Wisdom is the beginning of knowledge. Okay. Proverbs 1:7. The fear of Yahweh Shem Rashai is the beginning of knowledge, but fools despise wisdom and instruction. My son, hear the instruction of the father and forsake not the law of the mother. So the mother is going into the wisdom. Okay. And the father is, of course, the Yahweh Shem Rashai. Okay. And but a lot of people, two-thirds of our people, they despise the Heavenly Father, okay? And we know that in the latter days that would happen, okay? Because the world, if the world loved you, or the world hated you, it hated me first.
Just to back up on the point of mother being wisdom, this is the book of 2 Ezra 13:54, and he reads, "For thou hast forsaken thy own way, and applied thy diligence unto my law, and sought it. Thy life hast thou ordered in wisdom, and hast called understanding thy mother."
Blanket. She always asks for you, and where are you going? Taking care of you, that's an example of a mother. You know, our spiritual mother, which is wisdom and understanding, she takes care of us, man, to walk in the path of righteousness.
Yep, real quick, Proverbs 4:1, hear ye the instruction of a mother, and attend to no understanding. For I give you good doctrine, forsake ye not my law.
Yep.
And the father, what gives you the law, sets your commandments. He is what basically that supposed to be that whipping stick. That's why Esau and Edom took the man out of the house, taking out the order. Real quick, Proverbs 3:8. It shall be health. Let me go five. Proverbs 3:5. Trust in Yahweh Shemashai with all thy heart. Yes, so your mind, keeping thy eyes singular. Lean not on thy own understanding, so don't lean on your own ways. Follow the law, statute, commandments that were given to you, because this is an instruction. This is an instruction manual on how to live and how to be able to survive.
And the number one is believing the report.
Yep.
You know?
Yep.
That's why the first commandment is, thou shalt not have any gods, other gods before me. It's like it. You know, Exodus 20:3.
And our people, what they worship, you know, baby Jesus. They worship Esau, Edom, chasing that bag. They're in that thug life, diva spirit, trusting on their own ways. When the Lord says, "What, depart out of this world, come up hither," that means come to the law, statute, commandments. Hearken to me before I destroy this place.
Transformed by the renewing of your mind.
Proverbs 3:6, in all thy ways acknowledge him, and it shall direct thy path in all thy ways. So whenever that you go to do something, even when you get into a car, you should be praying to the Heavenly Father that he's able to get you to that place. Before we come on the Masabat, the altar, pray before. Pray the Lord be able to protect you with the signs. Right? 7. Be not wise in thy own eyes, and fear Yahweh Shemashai, and depart from evil. Right? And evil goes into bad times. Depart from these wicked ways, that these abominations that Esau, Edom is pushing. What is he pushing? He's pushing the hot sauce. Now you have the monkey juice. Okay? And a lot of people are going to go down to the modern day Egyptian for help, okay? And it tells you not to trust thine enemy, like iron is rusted, so is his wickedness.
It also says the Egyptian shall help in vain, you know?
Don't trust him.
Isaiah 30:7.
Okay, because he is adverse.
And it says to no avail.
Yep,
to no avail.
Yep. And if he doeth good, he doeth unwillingly. At last he would declare his wickedness. Sirach 14:7.
Yep.
And that's what he's doing right now. A lot of people have they're doing the Harlem Shake, they're doing the Justin Bieber. Why? Because they trusted in Esau, Edom. Okay, and they're going to do it again because they're pushing it back out. That just happened yesterday, right? It says, 8, it shall be health to the navel and marrow to the bones. So what is health? Health to the navel. So when you think about when you were born, right, you had your umbilical cord that was connected to what? Your navel. When the woman is what? Wisdom, okay? And the marrow to the bones. The bones are what? Your house. Okay, your spiritual house being what? Built up. Lord willing, we're of the tabernacle of David. Right? So this is Proverbs 8:8. All the words of my mouth are righteousness. There is nothing forward or perverse in them. Yeah, so it's not perverse to not eat pork.
Yeah.
Okay? It's not perverse to not trust in Esau. Because he's known as death. Okay? And he pushes what? Hell. Which is a hell is what? Condition played out on earth. Right? 9. They are all plain to him that had understanding, and right to them that find knowledge. So these things are plain upon tables for those that have the understanding, that have been given what the mysteries. Right? Shalom.
Hey, shalom.
Yahweh Shem
Rashi.
10. Receive my instruction, and not silver or knowledge rather than choice gold. So receive my instruction, which is what? Telling you what? To fear the Heavenly Father. 11. For wisdom is better than rubies, and all these things that may be desired are not to be compared to it. So nothing can be compared to this wisdom that we're bringing out in Sirach 17:5, those 7 operational skills, right? 12, I wisdom dwell with prudence and find out knowledge of witty inventions. So what's a witty invention? Esau, Edom coming with the wiles of the devil, coming with what, that karagma, which is an implant, which is implant into your body, which is something that is physical. Those that are not teaching that it's physical, okay, that they want to implement you to what, their technology, okay, then you're a false prophet. And if you offend thy little ones, it's better for you to have what, a great millstone wrapped around your neck and toss into the sea, which is the sea of what? The hypersonic missiles, okay? Because you don't fear the Heavenly Father. You want to come up your own lust and your own vainglory, okay? It says 13, end right here. It says, the fear of Yahweh Shema Shai is to hate evil and pride and arrogancy and the evil way and the forward mouth who I hate. Okay? So that's the, those are the things that the Lord hates. Your evil, you know, you're not following the law, church commandments, your pride.
I want to back you up on that real quick. Proverbs 6 and 16. These six things which the Lord hates. Yeah, seven are an abomination unto him. Abomination is something that he hates, something that's unclean. It tells you that in the book of Leviticus, the 11th chapter.
Also something that's worthy of you being put to death for.
Yep. It says, Proverbs 6 and 17, a proud look, a lying tongue, which also symbolic to Esau, he has a lying tongue, and hands that shed innocent blood. A heart that deviseth, there you go again, that word device. Wicked imaginations, like the karagma, feet that be swift in running to do mischief, a false witness that speaketh lies, and he that soweth discord amongst brethren. My son, keep thy father's commandment, and forsake not the law of thy mother. Woo. There you go again. The mother is embodied to wisdom and understanding.
What was that again?
Proverbs 6 and 20.
That's all I was looking for.
This is Proverbs 8 and 14.
Right here,
counsel is mine. So right now, the tabernacle of David, the counsel is being built up, starting with the head apostles at Great Millstone and the men on down that are what? Preaching the testimony of Yahweh Shai. Counsel is mine. Sound wisdom, I am understanding. I have strength. Okay? And he has strength. The strength in what, having wisdom, because that's going to be what the stability of your times. Okay? Roughly paraphrasing that. Right? And that goes into the treasure when you fear the Heavenly Father. So this is real quick, Proverbs 1 and 20. Wisdom cried without she utter her voice in the streets. That's why we're out here, because it's a commandment to feed thy sheep. John 21 and 17, if you love me, feed my sheep. And he was speaking to Simon, which is Peter, which is the head of the church. Okay, which we go into the word Peter, goes in the Petra, which goes in the rock. Okay, and that rock is that solid foundation that is Yahweh Shai.
Matthew 22 and 9, to back you up on that point, and he reads, I'll get 8. Then saith he to his servants, this is red writing, this is the words of Yahweh Shai, the wedding is ready, but they which were bidden were not worthy. Go ye therefore into the highways, and as many as ye shall find, bid to the marriage.
And how do you bid them to the marriage? First of all, by having the sign out there, okay? That's a centerpiece of, the northern and southern tribes coming back together.
Yep.
Okay, reuniting under what, Yahweh Shai. That is a prophecy that we would stand in what, a great army, and prophesy the downfall of this evil, wicked queendom. Okay?
And if you read up in Matthew 22, before Matthew 22 and 9, all those men were making excuses. That's why they weren't worthy.
Yep.
You know, because they didn't want to make their body a living sacrifice.
Yeah, I just got married.
I got land.
I got a job.
I got kids.
Yeah, and you see those same excuses today. Okay, because we should be fervent in the spirit. Look what's going on. You have the infrastructure of the karagma, which is the central bank and digital currency, okay, which is knocking out the paper dollar, bringing in the infrastructure of all these different blockchains. Okay, the petrodollar is out, right? You have Russia over there pushing pushing the ruble. Then you have China with the UN. Okay, so you see the petrodollar, and it always was nothing. Okay, because it's not backed by gold or silver.
And it's not about what you're going through. It's about, you know, what lengths are you willing to do or willing to go to go out there and make your body a living sacrifice. This brother right here just got in an accident yesterday.
Man.
They had to catch an Uber here, but he's here, you know?
Hey, Yahweh Shai spoke about going that extra mile.
Yeah.
That's Matthew 24.
Yeah, it's all about going through what the adversities, you know, dealing with the infirmities, you know, that all the different elements, and the Lord loves a man that what keeps fighting, okay? Because again, all these things are really set up to harden our hearts for the things that are about to really happen if we're of that elect, because we're going to see a lot of death, and we're going to have to be mentally, physically, and spiritually fit. We're going to have a put on the shelter and the wisdom of Yahweh Shema Shai. And it starts with doing the work, okay? Being fervent in the spirit, because the Lord is going to put that covering around his elect. So Proverbs 1 and 21, she cried in the chief place of concourse, in the openings of the gates, in the city, she uttereth her word, saying, and that her speaking about wisdom. So that's what we're doing. We're uttering the word of Yahweh Shema Shai, because these words are, Yahweh Shai is also known as what? Faithful and true. Okay? And these words are able to get comfort. And right now, the brothers are what? Rejoicing. The men of the Lord, the true men of the Lord, are rejoicing because these things are, the prophecies are manifesting. Okay? Esau, Edom's trying to come in like a flood. He has his super soldiers. He has his peacekeepers. He has his United Nations and General Assembly. They're all set up. And the Lord's going to lift up that standard for the elect. Okay? And that's why it's important to what? Again, do the work. You make your body a living sacrifice, like the brother Ash said.
Real quick, Luke 21 and 25. I'll get 28. Slack it. And when you see when these things begin to come to pass, look up and lift up your heads, for your redemption draweth nigh.
Yep. Because we're seeing that. I think it's the next chapter up where it speaks about the perplexity. You're seeing that the resources are being dried out by what they shut down. What, 100, over 100 food operational centers are being burned down.
Yep.
They're buying up all the farmland.
Well, you're starting to see all the points in the spiritual checklist being marked off. That's basically coming to pass. Then pushing the MOTB in the form of, they have it on television. You know, they're introducing it on the news. You can buy one. You can go to walletmore.com and buy, you know, and buy a implant, man. You know.
And
Neuralink, a company beat Neuralink to the punch as far as implementing
Secron.
Secron. You know, you have the worldwide family being ruled, the mass awakening. You have people coming in the house of Saul, false prophets. You have unbelievers, people coming to the comic board. There was 10 people on the comic board on Wednesday scoffing. You know, also you see other things happening in the form of, you know, the Euphrates River drying up, earthquakes in diverse places, uproars of the people. Those are all end time prophecies, man.
Also, real quick, bro, on the way over here, we saw a sign that said, what? Superior drought in California.
Yeah.
That's an example of, you know, it will break loose.
The pestilence, people out there getting those grievous swords, you know, because they trust it in the shadow of Egypt, you know?
So all these things are here. So that's why it's important to Surah 39 and 1 to be occupied in the meditation thereof, which is what? Prophecy. To be watching as well as praying, as the brother brought out in Luke 21, because the Lord is here. Okay, you have the sense of the chariots, okay? And you saw Edom is coming more draconian.
Yep.
He just took away those two horns, the Democrat and the Republican. Okay, now he's speaking with that. He wants to give you salvation through what that land. That's Revelation 13:11.
Starting to speak like a dragon.
Yeah, he's starting to speak like draconian. And how is the draconian measured? By passing that H.R. 4350, which is a dictatorship where the president doesn't have to go to the House or the Senate. Okay, which means that's ultimately at least to what? Martial law. Okay, and that's what the prophets, the men of the Lord, have been speaking about. There's going to be a martial law. They have the FEMA camps. They have all these things set up. Okay, and they're not set up for no reason. Okay, it speaks about that in the Revelation 11, the 10 parts, which is speaking about FEMA, these FEMA zones, these internment camps. Why do you think,
that's the same thing Antiochus was back in the day. He was a dictator.
Yep.
You know?
Yep. And that's what they're trying to beat. That goes into democracy. Okay. What speaking? Which democracy just creates a tyranny, which creates an evil a dictatorship, as the brother brought out, an evil rulership. That's what I'm trying to say.
Yep.
Okay. Evil rulership. And now they have, because why? They know that they have but a short time, so they have to be draconian, which is what? That great sword is being furbished, and the Lord is also bringing out with that black horse, which is the balances of righteousness and wickedness.
Got a precept, brother?
I got a Wisdom of Solomon 7:28.
Yep.
It says, God loveth none but him that dwelleth with wisdom.
Yep.
You see? So we know the beginning of the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. He that keepeth his commandments, you know, have a good understanding. So the wisdom of knowing what part of prophecy you're in, to know what time in judgment we're in, as well as keeping the commandments in the faith of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai.
Yep, keeping the commandments to the best of our abilities, you know, because we know the commandments won't save us, but we're rehearsing the righteous acts. And also, wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times, you know? You know?
Yep.
Because we're the only ones that are stable, as far as those that are in the knowledge, those that are in the understanding, those that are in the house, you know? In the form of everybody else's bugged up. You see people walking down the street with two masks on, you know, scared to touch anything. They're driving down the street with gloves on, with masks on, windows fully rolled up. You know, you have a lot of our people, they've been seduced by the enchantments and the witchcraft that they see on television. You see a lot of people walking down the street, they have their fingernails painted. You know, that's that wine of Babylon.
Right.
Real quick, just to back up the brother real quick, Sirach 19 and 18, and he reads, the fear of the Lord is the first step to be accepted of him, and wisdom obtaineth his love. Real quick, Sirach 19 and 20. The fear of the Lord is all wisdom, and in all wisdom, performance of the law, and the knowledge of his omnipotency. His omnipotency. Because the Lord is all-seeing and all-powerful. Real quick.
I'm not bonusing, which means what? He controls the left and the right. See, a lot of people don't have that understanding. They don't know that our Lord also, he brings forth the wickedness. He created the wicked. Okay? Just like he created the tabernacle of David.
You want to get Deuteronomy 32 and 39, okay, brother? Did you have the phone whipped out? I get one more precept. Sirach 19 and 22. The knowledge of wickedness is not wisdom, neither at any time the counsel of sinners prudence. And that's what Esau Edom pushes, the knowledge of wickedness, the spirit of rebellion, do art thou will, you know?
Because ultimately his wisdom is for his destruction.
Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
And our and the wisdom that Yahweh Shemashai has given the men of the Lord, Lord willing, we're of that number, is to be able to endure to the end.
And also Proverbs 16 and 4 backs that point up. The Lord Yahweh Shemashai created all things, even the wicked, for the day of evil.
Yep.
Mm, right.
Yeah, that's what he's on the earth to do, to fulfill the prophecy of being the wicked one, yep, you know, the son of perdition. Got that, brother?
All right, this is Deuteronomy 32 and verse 39.
Beautiful.
It says, see, now that I, even I am he,
yep,
there is no God with me. I kill and I make alive. I wound and I heal.
I kill and I make alive. I wound, yep, and I heal. Yep. That's both sides. You know what I'm saying?
Yep, and also I make alive. What is he doing? He's raising up the men of the Lord that were spiritually sick.
Yep.
Okay, spiritually dead for what, those 3 days?
Yep.
Okay, what, put, and raising them up, breath of life?
Yep, putting the skin on them,
yep,
you
yep,
know, through the word.
The marrow.
And then yep, some getting the skin and the breath.
Yep.
Because you have a lot of our people, they just got the skin. They know that there is a life, but you, if you ask them, you know, who's the wicked, they're going to say, you know, the Most High loves everybody. Or what's the karagma in Revelation 13 and 16? Oh, it's a spiritual mark. Well, where is the end he calls it for the spiritual mark? Well, what we teach, we can actually point out in the earth of where they're getting ready. That word causeth is poieo, which means to get ready, to be the author of, to set up, to fashion, you know? Right now, they're fashioning society and the whole world in a way where everything is going digital. There's no setting up for a spiritual karagma. There's no setting up to, you can buy with Wiccan philosophies. You know, you can buy by being a reprobate. You can't buy and sell with that, you know?
Yeah, because they're giving you the warning. They're telling you there's going to be blackouts. Okay? Look at Canada. What they did, they cut off the banking. You're not able to access
China. They got the tanks in the street.
Yeah, they got the tanks. So, and that's coming to Babylon the Great. Babylon means confusion.
And they're not putting the tanks in the street over philosophies.
Exactly.
They're putting the tanks in the street over people protesting the government because they can't access their bank accounts, man.
Yep.
And that's not something spiritual. That's something physical you have to get as far as buying and selling, man.
And that's the Hegelian dialect, the problem, action, solution. See, the problem is you can't get money. The action, right, the people wilding out, and then, hey, here's the solution. Here's the device.
Yep.
Hey, we'll help you out.
China already has a social credit system society set up.
Yep.
They're the... They're the guinea pig right now for the New World Order.
Look at this dude. See, our people, that's how our people look. They got, you know, the congregation of the dead.
Yeah,
just grew. You know what I mean?
He that wandered out of the way of understanding shall remain the congregation of the dead.
Yeah,
you know,
so
those are those dead bodies that's being talked about in the book of Revelation, the 11th chapter, the 8th verse.
So this is Proverbs 1 and 22. How
are people dead from the neck up, not knowing who they are, not knowing who the enemy is, and not knowing what's to come, which is the famine, death, and destruction, you know? And then deliverance for the elect. That's perfect balance.
Yep, because they don't have what the comforter, which is the physician, which is Yaharashai, which is this word, which is this truth, which is this light. Okay, which means if you have no light, you have no truth, that means you're in darkness, okay? This is Proverbs 1 and 22. How long, you simple ones, when you love simplicity? And the scorners delight in scorning, and fools hate knowledge. Yeah, so you have, like the brother was speaking about, the mockers and the scoffers. They hate knowledge. They hate being corrected. You know, they hate being rebuked. Okay, but this ministry is all about being rebuked. The Lord is refining his men to be able to be what? Posterior men, and to be soldiers, to be judges ultimately, right? 23.
That goes back to the law, real quick. Deuteronomy 16 and 19. Let's lock it. I'll get it real quick. It's also Leviticus.
Proverbs 1 and 23. Turn you at reproof. 16. Behold, I will pour out my spirit unto you. I will make known my words unto you. So again, going into that, the Lord quickening you. And when you go into, what is that, Revelation 3 and 20, it goes into the Lord, what's supping with you, okay?
Yep.
And sup, which means when you go into the word, it goes to be intimate.
Yep.
The Lord is being intimate with his elect.
Intimate love.
Working, what's that, Job 33 and 15, where it speaks about the word works what's on your mind. Yep. Okay, and then it gives you the instruction for the day. You know,
because
The Lord is the one that trains our hands for battle, because we're in a spiritual battle right now. Okay, and he's gearing us up for this war, standing what in that Ezekiel 37. I keep bringing it back up. You know, standing in what that great army, because most of our people, they don't know that we're in a war. They don't even know. They don't know that all around us, this devil is lurking in the secret places, seeking who he may devour.
I got it. I found it. What I happened to look it up. Let's bring it out. This is Deuteronomy 19:17, as far as rebuke, that goes back to the law. And it reads, thou shalt not hate thy brother in thy heart. Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor and not suffer sin upon him. It didn't say thou shalt not. It says thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor. You know? Because you don't want to suffer sin upon him. You know, if I see you going off and I don't warn you or just at least get on you, that means I hate you.
The blood is on my hands. Yeah. Ezekiel 3:19 speaks about that. Okay? So this is a Proverbs 1:24. Because I've called you and you refuse, I stretch out my hand and no man regarded. So how is the Lord stretching out his hand? Through Yahrashai, using his hands, which are the prophets, to be able to give you warning. Because that is, what is that, 2 Chronicles 36, where it speaks about...
Get 2 Chronicles 20:20.
Yeah, the Lord speaks about he will give his people warning before the destruction comes.
I got a quick precept real back here. Warning. Ezekiel 3:17, son of man, I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel.
Yep.
Therefore hear the word at my mouth and give them warning from me.
And the watchmen are what the prophets. Because again, back in the days, you would have the watchmen sit upon the tower, okay, which is this word. And the tower also goes into what the internet and what watching as well as praying, bringing it out. Watching for what's going to happen when they bring the infrastructure, giving our people warning. Okay, the enemy's coming. He's right there. Okay, which he is. He's right. He's watching us right now on film. Okay.
Yeah. He sends scoffers and mockers on the comment boards with different profile names, lugged out profile names. Yeah. We seen them on Wednesday.
Yeah. Okay.
Coming in by the boatload, man. Yeah. 2 Chronicles 20. And 20.
All right, 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 20.
Yep.
And they rose early in the morning and went forth into the wilderness of Tekoa.
Beautiful.
And as they went forth.
Babylon the Great. This is a modern-day wilderness. Go ahead, bro.
And as they went forth, Jehoshaphat stood and said, hear me, O Judah, and ye inhabitants of Jerusalem. Believe in the Lord your God, so shall ye be established. Yep. Believe his prophets.
Believe his prophets.
So shall ye prosper.
Yep, because the Lord's not going to step off his throne and break down the word to you. He's going to send his men. You want to get Malachi 2:7, brother?
Proverbs 1:25, but you have set at naught of my counsel and would none of my reproof. I will also laugh at your calamity. I will mock when your fear cometh. When your fear cometh as a desolation and your destruction cometh as a whirlwind, when distress and anguish come upon you. So again, that's what you're about to see. Because again, they're weaponizing the food. Okay, they're going to break that staff of bread. Everybody that's on, have EBT or have Section 8, any of these things, all these programs are going to be broken down. There's not going to be no more water. Why? Because when a blackout happens or EMP hits, then there's no water coming in because they run it through a computer system. Okay, so again, you're not going to have these luxuries. That's why you have to have that hedge, which is Yahweh Shema Shai, the covering. Okay, that covering. And those that don't have the covering of Yahweh Shema Shai, they're going to be out there and they're going to get caught up in the set perils. Bloodshed, strife, calamity. Okay, and the Lord's going to laugh at you through his prophets.
All right, Malachi chapter 2 and verse 7. For the priest's lips should keep knowledge.
And wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times. You know, he that believeth in the scripture said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water, which is the wisdom, knowledge, understanding of the scriptures.
And they should seek the law at his mouth, for he is the messenger of the Lord of hosts.
Yep, the priests are the messengers of Yahweh Shem Yahshai. And through Yahweh Shai's sacrifice, the priesthood is opened up to all 12 tribes. It's not just about the sons of Levi anymore, you know, it's more of the sons of Aaron.
This goes back to Sirach 7, having those senses and being able to understand those mysteries with the prophets, which are the messengers. You have messengers that are in the celestial bodies, which are in the flesh, and then you have messengers that are what? In the celestial bodies. Okay? And they both do the bidding of our Lord, which is to bring in prophecy, right? And to report on what's happening down here in Babylon the Great.
And if you go into that word messenger, it means malach, which also is an angel or a messenger as far as a prophet, you know?
Beautiful. And they all have what? Revelation 19.
One's in the celestial body, and one's in the terrestrial body. I get a quick precept that backs it up. Revelation
19, for those that know, you know. Yeah. This is Revelation 19 and 10. And it reads, "And I fell at his feet to worship him. And he said unto me, See thou do it not. I am thy fellow servant and of thy brethren that have the testimony of Yahweh Shai. Worship the Most High, for the testimony of Yahweh Shai is the spirit of prophecy." So they both had the testimony of Yahweh Shai. John, you know, John the Revelator, you know, the Apostle John, and the angel, you know.
And prophecy means the what? Forecast the future events that are about to happen. And they're also, what, 1 Samuel 9 and 9, that are also known as the seers. Yep. And what the Lord has opened up our eyes to, what, let me bring this out again, Sirach 17 and 5, to finish it out, it says they received the use of five operations of Yahweh Shemashai, and the sixth plague, he imparted them understanding, and the seventh speech, the interpreter of cognitations thereof, counsel and tongue, and eyes and ears, a heart, gave him to understand, whether he filled them with knowledge of understanding and showed them good and evil. So again, that's what the Lord is showing the men of the Lord, showing you what the wicked, okay, and how not to run a kingdom, and ultimately being to be able to be those judges, okay, to be able to spiritually discern right from wrong. Omnipotent, like we read in Deuteronomy 32 and 39, we're speaking about our Lord. Our Lord is omnipotent, and he's raising up what little Yahweh Shai, okay, as far as with the testimony, you know, the testimony of the Lord. You know what I mean? Yeah. Little prototypes, because it says Matthew 5:48, we shall be perfect like Yahweh. Okay, we shall, and then also Yahweh Shai said we shall do greater works than him. Okay? And we believe in that.
Real quick, to back you up on the point of, you know, the angels, as well as us, who are angels, you know, in chains of darkness. You know, this is 1 Peter 1 and 12, unto whom it was, unto whom it was revealed that not unto themselves, but unto us, they did minister the things which are now reported unto you by them that have preached the gospel unto you with the Holy Spirit sent down from heaven, which things the angels desire to look into.
Mm.
Because, you know, the angels, they desire to look into the things that we do, that, you know, to go into the word and break it down and go into the blue letter and, you know, so on and so forth, man. So, because, you know, we're given the mysteries from up on high, man.
You know, real quick, this is Sirach 17 and 8. He set his eye upon their hearts, okay? Yeah, his eye. So what? The understanding, right? On the hearts, which is in Lahab, right? It says, that he might show them the greatness of his works. He gave them glory and marvelous acts forever. So these are marvelous acts right now. So what? To be out here on the highways and the byways and preach and teach and give our people, and also when you go into warning, it goes into preach and teach. Give the people warning about what's about to happen. It's truly an honor that the Lord has given us. It's a gift, Ephesians 2 and 8. Okay, from up high.
What's the highest calling?
Yeah, the highest, yeah. I mean, that's why when it goes into the seventh operation, so you have regular people, they have five operations, okay? But the prophets have seven to be able to interpret what's going on through the scriptures and be able to, what, give this testimony, give this word, okay, which is his work, which is Yahweh Shai. It says, Sirach 17 and 8, he set his eye upon their hearts that he might show them greatness of works. He gave them glory and marvelous acts forever. So going back to the everlasting kingdom, it's not for 1,000 years. We're not going to do all this work. Okay, Yahweh Shai did a sacrifice and then it's going to be for 1,000 years. That don't make no sense. The Lord is not the author of confusion.
Can I get a quick piece at the back of you? This is Isaiah 6. I'm going to start from the top. Yep. And in the year of King Uzziah, and in the year that King Uzziah died, I also saw the Lord Yahweh Shai sitting upon a throne high and lifted up, and his train filled the temple. Above it stood the seraphims, angels, you know, guardian angels. Each one had six wings. With twain he covered his face, and with twain he covered his feet, and with twain he did fly, twain being two. One cried to another, saying, Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts, the Lord. The whole earth is full of his glory, because the Lord has angels that just give praise unto him 24/7. And the post of the door was moved at the voice of him that cried, and the house was filled with smoke. This is the point right here. Then said I, woe is me, for I am undone, because I am a man of unclean lips. Isaiah didn't feel worthy, you know? I dwell in the midst of a people with unclean lips, for my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts. This is the point right here. Then flew one of the seraphims unto me, having a live coal in his hand, which we had taken with the tongs from off the altar.
and laid it upon my mouth and said, lo, this hath touched thy lips, and thine iniquity is taken away, and thy sin purged. And that's coming straight from the spiritual realm. Yeah. So the prophets have the luxury of giving this, of getting the secrets on high straight from the spiritual realm, you know, and being able to make it plain upon tables to those who are believers. You want to get 2 Exodus 12 and 36, brother?
And the Lord has what power, was that Matthew 9 and 6, to what? Pardon sins. To be able to forgive sins, our Yahweh Shai. Okay? That's why it's important you kiss that royal son, unless he be mad or he catch you in your activities. Catch you when you think that you're doing something of this world. Okay?
One more precept. This is Isaiah 6 and 8, and it reads, also I heard a voice of the Lord saying, whom shall I send? Who will go for us? Then said I, here am I, send me. And that's us, you know, coming back in the last days, man. You know, that's our mentality. As soon as we heard the word, you know, we got quickened up through the spirit by studying, by praying, by listening, by fasting, taking notes, applying ourselves. And then we went and ran as soon as we were able to get out there in the highways and byways. You know, run, young men, run, man.
Yep.
Into the highways and byways.
Because of the elect. Okay, so let's speak about the elect real quick. The elect is going to inquire these things. Okay? The two-thirds, because people, there's people that are of Israel. They might know they're Israelites, right? But they're not of the elect. We're praying that we're of the hopeful elect. That's why we're praying we're the hopeful elect.
Well, the next precept goes into that.
I get
it. Isaiah the 6th chapter.
Yeah.
Yep. Because, and that's also.
Let me bring this out. Quoted
in Matthew the 13th chapter. You know?
Let me bring this out because it goes right back into that. This is Sirach 17 and 9. He gave them the glory to his marvelous acts forever, that he might declare his works with understanding. And the elect shall praise his holy name. Okay.
Declare his works with understanding. Yep. Now let's go into the Apocrypha real quick in 2 Ezra the 12th chapter.
All right, 2 Ezra chapter 12 and verse 36.
Yep.
It says, thou only hast been meet to know this secret of the highest.
Yep, been meet to may know the secret of the highest. Keep on reading, bro.
Therefore write all these things that thou hast seen in a book and hide them.
Yep.
And teach them to the wise of the people, whose hearts thou knowest may comprehend and keep these secrets.
Yep, beautiful. That's go to 2 Ezra 14 and 41.
I got a quick precept according to the word secret.
Yep.
Psalms 25 and 14. The secret of Yahweh is with them that fear him, and he will show them his covenant. That covenant goes into the word contract. So Yahweh Hashem El Shai has given the prophets, okay, his contract, his covenant, so they can fulfill it in these last days, man.
Real quick, 2 Ezra 12 and 36 is going to add on to the same thing, far as we're speaking about the mysteries.
Some precepts are so nice, you got to read them twice.
Is that the
you
same one?
You got to read them three times.
What is it?
It's all good, brother. Bring it out again. Bring it out.
I got another one.
Bring it out.
I'm going to get another one. 2 Ezra 10.
This is Isaiah 6 and 9, just to add perfect balance. And he said, go and tell this people, hear ye indeed and understand not, see ye indeed, and but perceive not. So you have angels who are actually given the duty of giving men the understanding straight from the altar, you know, putting straight from the tongues off the altar, as far as giving men the understanding, which is symbolic of the word. Giving the understanding of the word, because the word is fire. And our Lord's, it's a consuming fire. You know, Deuteronomy 4 and 24, you know?
I got one.
And it
right.
Also talks about the angels being ministers, being spirits of consuming.
Real quick. Job 33 and 15, in a dream, in a vision of the night, when deep sleep fall upon you, men in slumberings upon the bed, they open their ears of men that seal the instruction.
Yep.
Okay, so who's sealing the instruction? It's the celestial angels working on your mind to be able to have the understanding. This is real quick, 2 Ezra 10 and 56, and then shall hear as much as thy ears may comprehend, for thou art blessed above many other, and are the called with the highest, and so are but few. Yeah, many are called, but few are chosen. The harvest is plenty, but the laborers are few. It says 58, but tomorrow at night they shall remain here, and you shall say, the highest shall show these visions. Yeah, the visions goes into the judgments of the high things which the Most High will do unto them that dwell upon the earth in the last days. Okay, the plagues, right? It says, so I slept that night, and another like as commanded me. So commanded what? To be able to have the instruction to what? Bring forth the ministry. For the ministry. Okay?
This is Hebrews 101. I'm gonna go down to 12, and I'm gonna go down to 14. I'm gonna go down to 13. I'm gonna pass it on. And it reads, the Most High, who at sundry times in diverse manners spake in times past unto the fathers by the prophets. So the Lord speaks unto the people by the prophets. This is Hebrews 1 and Hebrews 1. And, man, I just had it right here. Hebrews 1. Let's lock it. I just had it right here. Angel, spirit of fire. Yep. Let's lock it.
I got one while you find that.
Because again, if you don't have this understanding, this is what's going to happen.
Oh yeah, this is Hebrews 1 and 7. And of the angels, he said, who maketh his angels spirits and his ministers a flame of fire. Hebrews 1 and 14. Are they not all ministering spirits sent forth to minister for them who shall be heirs of salvation? You know?
Heirs of salvation.
Yep.
Right, going into what the tabernacle of David. Because if this is what's going to happen, if you don't...
I'm trying to find the precept without having to look it up on the phone.
Yeah.
Because pretty soon we're not going to have the luxury of being able to go to the internet. We're going to have to be able to have it in our head. Like Book of Eli.
Yeah.
Denzel had the whole role in his head, man.
This is Wisdom of Solomon chapter 7 and verse 10. It says, I loved her above health and beauty and have chose her instead of light. So when you come into this ministry, you know, some people's like, oh, I don't want to be a part of, you know, those weird guys wearing those weird garments. So you may have to, you know, look shaggy and not line your beard up, you know. It says, for the light that cometh from her never goeth out. Okay.
And that's talking about wisdom, you know.
Because if you don't have wisdom, this is what's going to happen. This is going to be the time of Jacob's trouble. Sirach 40 and 9, death and bloodshed, strife and sword. Calamities, famine, and tribulation, and the scourge. Because again, wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times. The fear of the Lord is a treasure. Okay? It says 10, these things are created for the wicked, and for their sakes came the flood. Yet he saw Edom coming with his proud waters, coming with his United Nations soldiers, coming with his martial law, coming with his draconian measures. Okay?
Sirach 15 and 4, going back into wisdom, he shall be stayed upon her. Who's the her? Sophia, wisdom. And shall not be moved, and shall rely upon her, and shall not be confounded. Where is it also said? Israel, you shall not be ashamed nor confounded, world without end.
That's in Romans 12 and Isaiah.
Yep. 5. Yep. This is Sirach 15 and 6, and it reads, I'm going to get 7. Yep. I'm going to get 6. He shall find joy and a crown of gladness. And she shall cause him to inherit an everlasting name. An everlasting name. You know? Going into you not dying. You know? This is Sirach 15 and 7. And it reads, but foolish men shall not attain to her. But foolish men shall not attain unto her. And sinners shall not see her. For she is far from pride. And men that are liars cannot remember her. There, I will stir up your pure minds. I will stir up your pure minds by way of remembrance. You know, blessed is the memory of the just. You know,
real quick, this
Proverbs
is,
10 and 7. You know,
because only the elect's going to be able to attain what the truth, while the rest were blinded by what the God of this world. And that goes back to Genesis. You know, back in the garden. This is Genesis 3 and 24.
Real quick, one more. Proverbs. This is Sirach 15 and 10. For praise shall be uttered in wisdom, and the Lord will prosper.
Will make you live, because the Lord is the one that makes it prosper. That's why it's important that you again kiss thy royal son, right? Rehearse the righteous acts and be repentful, be merciful for the things that you've done in your past life and in this life, praying that He's able to pardon your sins. That's why it speaks about in Exodus, you know, provoke Him not, and that goes into the angel, which is your heart shot. Right? So this is Genesis 3 and 24. So he drove out the men in place of the east of the... And then, real quick, Genesis is the beginning. Okay? So in the beginning, there was already people being blinded. Right? By what? They didn't have the truth. Right?
They didn't have the seven senses.
Right? Yeah. Genesis 3 and 24. So he drove out the men in place at the east of the garden, Eden, cherubims, which are what? The angels, right? And a flaming sword, which turned every way to keep the way of tree of life. So again, at every single way, that sword, which is this word, because what? Hebrews 4 and 12, the cutting asunder, this word will cut you to be righteous or to be wicked, okay? And it's a spiritual discerner. And so that sword is what? Blocking 2/3 of our people from what? Getting this knowledge, wisdom, understanding. Okay, they have what? Slumber eyes. Right.
This is 2 Peter 1 and 12 and 13. Wherefore, I will not be negligent to put you always in remembrance of these things, though ye know them, and be established in the present truth. Yea, I think it meet, as long as I'm in this tabernacle, to stir you up by putting you in remembrance.
Remembrance, which means that you knew these things before.
Yep.
Okay, that's why when certain scriptures happen, you're able to, what? Oh, okay, I remember that. And you're able to go on. The Lord is doing that by giving you what that breath of life. Okay? Restoring back to what the kingdom, the tabernacle of David, restoring back those warriors.
This is Sirach 27 and 8, and it reads, if thou followest righteousness, thou shalt obtain her and put her on as a glorious long robe. The birds will resort unto their like, so will truth return unto them that practice in her. Return, you know, being put in remembrance, man, through what? Through the scriptures, man.
Yep.
You know?
And you're going to what?
Through men going out there and making their bodies a living sacrifice, man.
Because again, going into what, you're not going to be around men that are not teaching the truth. One's teaching the Karagma, and one's teaching the Karagma it's a Christianity or it's a white woman. You're not going to be hanging out with them. You can't have unity camps with those people because what? They're not teaching sound doctrine. Okay?
That's following.
And that goes into what the flock. You're not birds going to flock to birds. You know, lions going to flock to lions. You're not going to be, you know, right? Real quick, this is 2 Ezra's.
Also, we were talking about this in the car. I got to get it. This is Sirach 14, and it reads, Sirach 14. I was going over this precept in the car with you.
Okay,
this is Sirach 14, and it reads 14 and 10. And it reads, my son, according to thy ability, do good to thyself and give the Lord his due offering. That means putting up a acceptable sacrifice, you know? Get Malachi 1 and 6, brother, and then 7.
Because
and
you had, 7. Back in the day, you had people that were, offering up unclean sacrifices.
Yeah, that Malachi, the first chapter, goes into it. Yeah. We'll just get there real quick. I'll let the brother get it.
All right, book of Malachi, chapter 1.
Verses 6 and 7.
And verse 6.
Yep.
It says, a son honoreth his father, and a servant his master.
Yep.
If then I be a father, where is my honor?
Where is my honor? That's what Yahweh Bashem Yahshai is saying unto men who aren't putting up a righteous sacrifice. You know, they're not teaching the name, and they're not teaching the doctrine in its entirety. You know, they're adding and subtracting from the word. Keep on going, brother.
And if I be a master, where is my fear?
Where is my fear? You know, you shall not add or subtract to the word, and you shall not defile the name of the Lord. You know, we're paraphrasing, you know. You shall not take the name of the Lord in vain. Yahweh Bashem Yahshai.
It says, saith the Lord of hosts unto you, O priests that despise my name.
O priests that despise thy name. That speaks for itself. We have a whole bunch of guys doing that. You know? I'll call you out today. IUIC, Sakari, you know? Also, WFI. Because you're coming in the name, but you're saying that the MOTB is not physical. You know? You're despising the name, which the name goes back to report, which also goes back to doctrine. And also his rank and his authority, because you're teaching doctrine of devils, man. You're teaching people to go take it. I've seen you say that, Adam Abbott. Go ahead and take it. You know, the Lord isn't going to get mad for you putting an implantable device in your body. Well, that goes back to the law. You know, you shall not make any cuttings in your flesh or any covenants with the heathen.
That also goes back to the spirit of Cain, because Cain was offering a wicked sacrifice.
Yep.
Going
into Sirach, the 14th chapter, real quick. My son, according to the ability, do good to thyself and give the Lord his due offering. That's playing his tables. Keep on reading, brother. Malachi 1 and 7.
It says, and ye say, wherein have we despised thy name?
Wherein have we despised thy name? Lord, Lord, did we prophesy in thy name? Did we not cast out devils in thy name?
I got you. Matthew 7 and 21. Not everyone said unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven.
Huh?
But he
dropped $10.
Let him get it.
But he that do where's
it? Yeah. Complete amount of money.
And they already stepped on it, bro, like without picking it up.
Yep. Matthew 7 and
21. Lord's will, we're giving the $10 to the Lord as far as a complete offering, you know?
Yeah. It says, Matthew 7 and 21, not everyone said unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of the Father, which is in heaven.
That's the spirit, right? That precept came out, the $10 drop.
Many will say to me in that day, Lord, Lord, have we prophesied in thy name? And the name have cast out devils? Yep. And the name done many wonderful works? Then I profess unto them, I never knew you, depart from me, you work iniquity.
So you're going to have men on the planet Earth who actually have the name, teaching in the name, and they're going to be rejected. Yep. Who fits that bill? The guys who are out there teaching you to take the MOTB, HOI, another one. ISUPK, another one. What's their report? Go take the juicy juice. You know? Now, according to my understanding, you know, Adam Abbott, they're against the juicy juice. And they're right on a lot of things. They're great teachers outside the MOTB. You can watch one of their lessons, and you can come up with a good 5, 10, you know, 15 precepts you probably never use in your repertoire. Yep. I give you that. But you're doing all that in vain. Psalms 127 and 1 and 2 tells us that, you know, they labor in vain. Except the Lord built the house, they that labor in vain. Bro, be paraphrasing. Because you're doing all that, and you're going off on the one prophecy you can't get wrong, even out of sincerity, man. And they're teaching people to go take it, you know?
But if you're offering one thing, you're offering the whole thing.
Yep.
That's the whole point.
A little leaven, yeah. The whole lump.
Yeah. Because again, you can't, and again, the brother brought out, that's the most important thing, because that goes into what the grievous sword, that you get caught up in the lake of fire. You can't come back from that, okay? The Lord's not going to be able to save you
in
the hour,
from it.
Yeah, the hour of temptation, okay? Because he tells you not to, okay? And he brought men, starting with the head apostles and the men on down that are preaching the words of Yahweh Shemesh Shai, okay? It tells you not to trust thy enemy.
Yep.
Why would you trust in something, a device that goes inside of you when simply, you know, anything that you put in your body, what starts to eat away at you?
What happened to never trust thy enemy?
Yep. Yep. 12 and 10. If adversity comes upon you, you shall find him there first.
Yep.
You know, and you know that he's what? You know, just like that. He'll go like that.
Yep.
You know what I mean? And then he'll shake his head and clap his convicting.
Woe unto them that trust in the arm of man.
Yep.
But blessed be the man that trusts in Yahweh Basha Yah Shah.
Yeah.
Jeremiah 17 and 5, and then Jeremiah 17 and 7.
So Revelation 2 and 14.
That was it.
That's it.
But I have a few things against thee, right, going into these false churches and false camps that teach false doctrine. But I have a few things against you, because thou hast there them that hold the doctrine of Balaam, who taught Balak to cast a stumbling block before the children of Israel, to eat things sacrificed unto idols, and to commit fornication.
Yep.
Yeah, taking the karagma as an example of committing fornication, man.
Because that means that you love Shaitan.
Yep.
You love the Shaitan. When the Lord is what, a jealous God. Okay, he said, I'm worshiping. That's the main reason why we're in this case, because we're worshiping after these idols, following after the calf, and different types of imagery, idols, okay?
Verse 15, so hast thou also them that hold the doctrine of the Nicolaitans, which thing I hate. Repent, or else I will come unto you quickly, and will fight against them with the sword of my mouth. And who is the sword of the mouth of the Heavenly Father?
It's in the law, you said?
The prophet said, said of prophets, okay, to rebuke man. It tells you that in Proverbs 15 and 10. Get there real quick. It goes into correction is grievous unto him that forsaketh the way. And the way is what? The way is Yahweh Shai. It tells you that in John 14 and 6, Yahweh Shai said what?
KJV.
I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me.
Sorry.
Proverbs 15 and 10.
I got you.
And also in Acts 3 and 22, it says that he that forsaketh the prophet shall be destroyed.
Acts 3 and 23.
Yep. Proverbs 15 and 10. Correction is grievous unto him.
Yep. It says correction is grievous unto him that forsaketh the way. Correction means to rebuke or to warn them. It tells you that in Ezekiel 3rd chapter.
It says, and hate, you forsaketh the way, and he that hated reproof
and
shall
he
die.
He that hated the correction, reproof shall what? Shall die.
God, this is 11. It says hell, which is a condition played out on earth.
And destruction.
Yep, and destruction are before Yahweh Shemar Shai. How much more than the hearts of the children of men?
And who is selling destruction? That's Esau. Have a look at the 2nd chapter.
And who are the children of men? Heathen nations.
Yep.
So you're being just like a heathen, you know. You're a spiritual heathen, man, to Yahweh Shem Yah Shai.
It says, a scorner loveth not one that reprove him, neither will go unto the wise. A merry heart maketh a cheerful countenance, but by sorrow heart and spirit is broken. Okay. So going into, and again,
and that's Jake waking up. You know, Eve right behind us is like, are you the Israelites? I was like, yeah. You know? We used to come out here and get mistaken for Muslims all the time, but now that spirit is upon Jake to recognize who we are through the spirit, you know?
And hopefully who they are.
Yeah.
Okay, that's why that sign is so
important. That's Matthew 24 and 14. And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached
in all nations,
you know, in all the world for a sign.
Yeah. I got it right here, bro. Bring it out.
Matthew 24. It's for witness, but witness also goes into sign.
Matthew 24 and 14.
A sign of who the Israelites are.
And this gospel, which is the word gospel in the Greek, is evangelium.
Good news.
Good news.
It's good news for us, and it's bad news for those who are outside the circle. You know, including 2/3 of our own people. That's how precious this thing is, man. Because in the first Egypt, Montezarium, house of bondage, all Israel was delivered. But not this time. Only a remnant, man. You know?
144,000 in the Commonwealth of believers.
Yep.
Okay? The rest are going to get destroyed. 2/3 of the people are going to get destroyed.
And if you go into John, the 17th chapter, I was reading it last night because I was actually going to go into a lesson. It says, Yahawashi, he only prayed for those that he sent and those that believed on the report. John 17 and 20, you know?
Because right before that, John 17 and 15, it speaks about the prayer that Yahawashi...
I'll just get it real quick because I was in John.
Yeah, because Yahawashi prayed for his elect. Because the prophets, the watchmen have to be here to be able to prophesy the kingdom.
John 17 and 9, I pray for them, those who he sent. Real quick, John 17 and 6. One of my favorite precepts. I have manifested thy name unto the men which thou gavest me out of the world. That world, that word world is Israel, going into order of government.
Manifest, make it obvious, make it plain.
Yep, okay. Every man is on order. Christ, the Slakia, Hamashiach, 1 Corinthians 15 and 23.
The first fruits,
and those that are Mashiach that is coming, and also Isaiah 9 and 6. You know, talking about the government, you know, Yahawashi being the head of that government. Yep. That government is Israel. If you read Isaiah 9 and 8, it talks about who is addressing. You want to get there real quick? Isaiah 9 and 6 down to 8. I have manifested thy name unto the men which thou gavest me out of the world. Thine they were, and thou gavest them me, and they have kept thy word. Now they have known all the things whatsoever thou hast given me are of thee, for I have given unto them the words. So he gave them the name and gave them the words, which is the report. I have given them the words which thou gavest me, and they have received them, and have surely, and have known surely, Slakia, that I came out from thee, and they have believed that thou didst send me. This is the point right here. I pray not, Slakia, I pray for them. I pray not for the world. That word world is cosmos. He didn't pray for the whole nation of Israel. He only prayed for the elect and those that would believe on the report. And that's how Kol Yahawashi is, man. He didn't pray for all Israel, man. You know?
So that's why
we get it when people don't understand. Going back to Isaiah the 6th chapter. How long shall they be blind? Till the missiles come, man. You know?
And then they shall understand death, as it speaks about in the Bible.
Yep.
Right. This is Luke.
At death by pain.
Luke
22 and 32.
That's why we're doing this. Because we don't want to be destroyed. We don't want the blood in our hands at the same time. You know, this is our duty. This is our heritage. You know?
This is Jeremiah 7 and 16.
You feel guilty if you miss camp, man.
Yep.
You know, you'd be like, damn, you know?
Yep. That's that shame.
You feel like, damn, it's a spirit.
You feel like you got the brothers down, you know what I mean?
It's a spirit still dealing with me, you know what I'm saying? Like, damn, you know?
That goes into examine thyself, be in the faith, be in the truth. Real quick, before you get that. Yep. Jeremiah 7 and 16. Therefore, pray not thou for these people.
Yep.
Neither lift up a cry nor prayer for them, neither make intercession to me, for I will not hear thee.
That was Jeremiah 7, right?
Yep.
11 and 14.
I got you. I was going to throw it right back.
Yeah, come.
Actually, I saw that video you did.
It's all good.
Yeah, that was the other one.
Yep,
so this one, this is Jeremiah 11 and 14. Yep. Therefore, pray not for the people, neither lift up a cry or prayer for them, for I will not hear them in the time that cry unto me for their trouble.
And it goes back to Proverbs, the first chapter. You know, I will laugh at your calamity, you know, because I have stretched out my hand and no man regarded. And also, it's written in the story that the Lord's going to do exactly that, you know? He's going to do that by sending his men, having you reject the word, and then you're going to run up to men in the last days, and where they're going to tell you. Jeremiah 15 and 2.
The mouth shall plead to the tongue.
Yep. To the captivity, the famine to the famine, to the sword to the sword.
I got you right here. Do you want to bring that up?
Oh, yeah, real quick, to back up Brother Hodge, because he brought out John 17 and 9.
Yep.
How shall I pray for the elect?
Let me finish that real quick. And it reads, I pray for them, I pray not for the world, but for them which thou hast given me, those who he gave the word to, and those who he gave his name to, his doctrine to. You know, those who he gave his name to, as far as the name, Yahweh Bashem Yahshai, and also those who he gave his report to, the word to. I pray for them. I pray not for the world, that word world is Israel, but for them which thou hast given me, for they are thine.
They're his. Okay? Because what Yahweh Shai is what the husband is.
Hear my voice?
Yeah, and we are his wife. And he's coming to what? Have those clean virgins as far as the cleansing of the word. That's where Ephesians 5 and 28 are cleansed.
Isaiah,
let's
get those.
Okay. Real quick, this is Luke 22 and 32. But it is red letters. Yeah. But I have prayed for you that thy faith fail not. And when thou art converted, strengthen thy brethren. So this is Yahweh Shai speaking to the brethren.
Yeah.
The word brethren in the Greek is identical, which means the Israelite brethren.
Good. And from the same national, descending from the same national ancestor forefather. You know, that's what brethren is. Yep. You know, kindred, you know, kinsmen. Yep. You know, relatives, you know?
Because that's why certain brothers follow certain brothers follow certain brothers, you know, far as the following. And they're able to have the understanding. Because every one of us, you know, we might follow the same people far as in the ministry, but some of us have better teachings from others.
Back up on that. This is Sirach 13 and 16. 15. Every beast loveth his life, and every man loveth his neighbor.
There you go.
Loving your neighbor, you know, Amos 3 and
hey, listen, man. Just listen.
And four, what is that? Can two walk together except they be agreed?
Yep. And when you love your neighbor, what? You give them the understanding of the scriptures. You're telling them who they are, okay, and what they need to do, right? And that's a righteous act, right?
Sirach 13 and 15. Every beast loveth his life, and every man loveth his neighbor. All flesh concerneth according to kind, and a man will cleave to his life.
That's the one.
Is that Proverbs?
Sirach 13.
Give Proverbs 12 and 10, brother.
What fellowship has the wolf with the lamb? Who's the wolf? Esau. And also, the wolf is two-thirds of our people that teach false doctrine. And the lamb is
those wolves,
Yahweh Shai.
Those wolves in sheep's clothing.
Yep.
You know, it says, hirelings.
So the sinner with the godly. What agreement is there between the hyena and a dog, and what peace between the rich and the poor?
Yep.
All right. Proverbs chapter 12, verse 10. It says, a righteous man regardeth the life of his beasts, but the tender mercies of the wicked are cruel.
Tender mercies of the wicked are cruel. What's Esau Edom looking to do? He says, oh yeah, it's all good. We got lab-grown meat for you. Yeah. You know, eat bugs. You know?
3D hamburgers.
Yeah, we got help for you. Take this juicy juice. Don't worry about the monkey bumps that come after that. Don't worry about being turned into a cyborg. Don't worry about GPS activation, you know, tracking near every single move after that. You know, don't worry about being a participant, you know, in the Bluetooth challenge.
Yeah, don't worry about being connected.
Don't worry about being connected, you know?
This is real quick.
And he's doing that right now, Slacky, brother. I'm in the spirit right now.
No, bring it out.
He's doing that to mentally condition the people. So when he rose at the Karagma, you've already went down this nigga 7 times. You know? That's like, for example, to throw a carnal example out there. You know, you got people out there selling drugs with fentanyl in it, man. You know, but you went to this nigga 8 times, you ain't dropped dead yet. You're so used to getting served by him. You're like, fuck it, I'll go see this nigga. I ain't dropping dead. Everybody else got this bullshit that's putting niggas down.
Yeah.
You know? That's what he's doing. He's conditioning you to trust him so he can kill you, man. You know? Or take your BMAT 2 gene away and take your seat in the chariot away. And it's Yahweh Shem Yahshai that's giving them the jurisdiction to do that, man. You know?
Yeah, because our Lord, the Lord has given us what's the wisdom.
It ain't Esau Edom's chip, it's the Lord's chip, man.
Yep.
You know?
To see if you're faithful and true. That 1 Peter 1 and 7, where this is the trial and testimony of our faith. We're going to be paraphrasing.
Yep.
So Romans 11 and 9. And David said, let their table be made a snare, and a trap, and a stumbling block, and a recompense unto them.
See that, bro?
Yeah,
this dude just walked by, just rolled by, and just wanted to take footage of us, man. Fucking devil.
I think you're talking about Shalak
Ram, that motherfucker, man.
Say some of that other devil that was right there.
Yeah.
It says Romans 11 and 7.
And he won't do that. He won't go down to those Catholic churches and approach those bishops and ask him how many boys they molested, man. You know,
right.
You won't go down there and protest that. You won't go into any of those Christian churches and tell them and tell those pastors they're going off, but you'll come down here to us with no congregation and film us, man, you know, and harass us, man, because you're the damn devil, man.
Romans 11 and 10, let their eyes be darkened that they may not see and bow down and back away. So all those people that were trusted in Esau, Edom, okay, all those mockers and scoffers like you just saw right there. Because see, the Lord, the thing is that the Lord, his eyes are set upon this place, upon this what, sinful kingdom. And he sees everything that's going on. okay, as far as these mockers and these scoffers. And real quick, this is going to be two-thirds of our people. Jeremiah 15:1 then said, Yahweh Hashem Rashai, that through Moses and Samuel stood before me. Yet my mind could not be towards these people, cast them out of their sight and let them go forth. So the Lord is casting two-thirds of his people out of his sight by giving them what the spirit of slumber eyes, by being blinded by the God of this world. Because if our gospel be hid, it's hid to those that are lost. Yeah, so you're lost in the sauce as far as the hot sauce that they gave you.
Just
right?
Real quick, Psalm 37 and 32, that's what happened right there. This is precepts talking. The wicked watcheth the righteous and seeketh to slay him. And that's what he's doing. He's sending out agents, you know, agent provocateurs, false teachers, you know. People actually coming up to the camp looking to try to fight. And you're going to have more and more of that as we get closer to the end. People coming up to the camp wanting to get carnal. What do you have happen with YC? Now, they instigated, but they got beat up by some Christians, and they had strap hold on them, man. Dude in the gray, he cocked back and was pointing at them, man. You know? And they asked for that because they're going out there teaching unbelievers, man. They've heard the report, and they rejected it. This is Psalms 37 and 34. Wait in the Lord and keep his way when he shall exalt thee to inherit the land. When the wicked are cut off, thou shalt see it.
And you know? The men of the Lord are going to be able to see the mass death. 2 Ezra 5:1 said it should be a mass death. And if we're able to endure to the end.
And it said the land shall be barren of faith. And iniquity.
2 Ezra 5, I got it right here.
2 Ezra 5, yeah.
Shall be increased.
1-3.
I got it right here. 2 Ezra 5:1. Nevertheless, as concerning the tokens,
the signs. The tokens, the signs.
The day shall come that they which dwell upon the earth shall be taken in a great number.
Yep.
Because real quick,
the day of the Lord comes as a thief in the night.
Yep. Because again, you're
those that aren't watching,
the elect are going to have to see their family members trying to eat their own children.
Cannibalism.
Okay, cannibalism, right? And you're going to have to see certain members of your family that
drop dead from the hot sauce.
Yep. Drop dead from the hot sauce. Okay. And you're going to see certain of also your family members turn on you. It says a man's foe shall be of his own household.
Yep.
Okay. And they're going to also try to tell the modern day Egyptian, okay, Esau, Edom, what you're doing and where you're at. Okay?
And we're not surprised at these things because the scriptures tell us these things are going to happen, man. Yep. That's the wisdom and knowledge and stability of thy times, is knowing that these things are going to happen. You know?
Okay.
That's being comforted, man. Knowing that these things are going to happen. So when they happen, we can go through the scriptures and be like, oh, okay.
Yeah, because the Lord has given us what? He's hardened our heart. This is Jeremiah 15:2. And it shall come to pass, if they say unto thee, whither shall we go forth? Then shall tell them that said Yahweh Hashem Rashai, such as for death to death, and such as for sword to sword, and such as for famine to famine, and such as captivity to captivity. So famine to famine, okay?
Yep.
We're in a food shortage that these devils have strategically planned, okay? Captivity to captivity, that goes to internment camp to internment camp, okay? Because again, they're gonna offer you to these idols. Okay, what's their idol? The karakwa, the graven image, in your forehead or in your hand, that they wanna implant into you, okay? Right? 3, I will appoint over them 4 punks that say Yahweh Hashem Rashai, the sword to slay and dogs to tear and fowls of the heaven and the beasts of the earth to devour and to destroy.
Jeremiah 3.
Yeah, because that's what these devils want to do. They want to the dogs to tear. What did they used to have back when we were in slavery? They had the dogs to tear. Okay, they would rip out of the Ephraim woman, okay? They would rip the baby out of the womb and they would feed it to the dogs.
Also, when it goes into beasts, it goes into Esau will use those alligators.
Yep.
We use alligators to eat
Jake,
especially
that goes into gator bait. Using our babies as gator bait. Okay?
Right here.
And then also
see the gators?
Yep. And then you have what?
The yoke of iron on Jake?
Yep.
You know?
Dogs to tear. What do they have now? They had back in, what is it, the 60s and 70s, they had. That's why a lot of Jake is afraid of dogs, because they used to have the dogs attack us. Now what do they have? They have knowledge shall be increased, Daniel 12:4. Now they have robot dogs that are able to sense who Jake is, and they have what?
They military had the Spanish mastiffs. When the Spaniards came over here, they had Spanish mastiffs that would detect, that would basically know who was Jake and who was the Spaniards, man.
Yep.
And they would use those dogs to put hell on our people, man.
Yep.
You know? And that was the indigenous people who were here before the Southern Kingdom came over here, man.
Yep.
You know?
And all those things are prepared for the wicked. All those are prepared for those that put on with those idol worship, right?
I got a quick precept. This is Psalms 22:16.
Yep.
For dogs have compassed me the assembly, which goes into Esau as well. Esau is known as a dog.
He is not that which is holy to the dogs.
It says, the assembly of the wicked have enclosed me, they pierce my hands and my feet. That goes into the outside. Down real quick to verse 20. Deliver my soul from the sword, my darling from the power of the dog. There you go, the dog goes into Esau. That also goes into the prayer of David. I'll save you from the sword, which is Esau's best.
All right, I got this real quick. This is Sirach chapter 39, verse 28. It says, there be spirits that are created for vengeance, which in their fury lay on sore strokes. In the time of destruction, they pour out their force and appease the wrath of him that made them.
Gun. Spirits created for vengeance. Look at Esau, Edom. That's the spirits created for vengeance. Okay, all these guys have the wicked part. Seizure force here, going back to Sir Rapis Christie, that's a wicked device. George Soros, what does he do? He funds Black Lives Matter, and Proud Boys, Antifa. Okay. And so these are these economic hitmen that they bring in. George Soros, under Henry A. Kissinger, they're all apprentices.
And okay? These are all fall guys for the most part. Because the real guys who are running things are these guys, man. The Rothschilds, the Rockefellers, and the people who are above them, which is the Oppenheimer family, man.
Yep.
You know? And the other crime families that are higher than the Rockefellers and the Rothschilds and the Oppenheimers, man.
Yep.
You know? The multi-trillionaires, man.
Yep.
You know, the 100-trillionaire club, man.
Secret government, the secret council of the wicked, like it tells you in Psalms 64.
And that's who our real enemy is, man. The average everyday Mountain Dew drinking, you know, Bud Light drinking, Bush Light drinking, Edomite. Yep. You're not even on the radar, man. You're just Goliath.
Yep.
Extra slaves for the kingdom, man.
And spirits created for vengeance, that also goes into 2/3 of our people.
Yep.
Okay, Jake, that's going to be out here, that are going to be rape, robbing, pillaging. Why? Because they don't have food. When that staff of bread is broken,
yep.
When you don't have food or water, those are going to be those spirits created. Those are going to be those spirits created for vengeance. Also, you have what? The super soldiers, okay, that they built. The Russian super soldiers, the Chinese super soldiers, okay, that are already set up. The sleeper cells that they have that are underground in these bunkers, that are sitting right there at the borders. The martial law, okay, these are all spirits created for vengeance. The people that are in the military, that are on that juicy juice, okay, and they're going to be what? They're going to turn on that 5G-60, and they're going to be what? Coming in like a flood. It says those proud waters.
And there's tens of thousands of those UN trucks, if not 100,000, in the United States and in Canada, man.
Yep.
You know?
And real quick.
And they're parked in random spots, man. Yep. And I've seen videos of them going back to 2012, 2013, and they would zoom in and you would see thousands and thousands and thousands of these UN trucks, man. And in those UN trucks, they have EMP, you know, they have gas and other things. You know, they have, some of them have firing, what's those, where they can actually shoot the strap?
Fire extinguisher, or not fire extinguisher, but the
shooting station, basically.
Yep.
You know, where you can't get in, they can shoot out, man.
Yep.
You know?
Yeah, that goes into their tanks. You have to think about what the 1033 program.
Look at Amalek.
Which is, and that's what Amalek does, knocking over trash cans. Yeah, you got a small hatter that just puts over a trash can for no reason, and he's a tough guy. See, that's what Esau Edom does. He's always in mischief. You know what I mean? He can never just be like chill.
Get Isaiah 24:4, bro. Real quick,
yeah, and so those spirits created for vengeance.
All we wanted to get was that one precept.
You got
bouncing around the A's, all good.
They domestically arm these police. The police that are staying on the forces, they are what? They have that hot sauce. And once that Warburg juice comes out, that's going to be the people that took the hot sauce. And they're going to
have this happening in the second year, bro. Yep. And I think also out there in North Carolina, I think the majority of the police force, they actually went there.
Yep. And also that happened in Colorado, too. The whole police force just left. And also over there in Atlanta. Because they know what's about to happen, and also in the military, we have the people that didn't want to take the hot sauce. Now they're actually in the military. Why? Because they don't want to comply to what Operation Hot Musky, okay? Which is they're going to wage war on the people. And that's what we're here to tell you, that they're going to wage war on these people. This is Sirach, actually slacking, Ecclesiastes 9 and 12. For a man also known at his time as the fishes that are taken in the evil net. And as the birds that are caught in the snare, so are the sons of men snared in the evil time when it falls suddenly upon them.
Yep.
So again, this is we're in the beginning stages of Jacob's trouble. And you got sharks, you know, the shark in the sky, right?
You got
sharks all around you. And this is Shark Week. This is going to be next shark for the next, what? Shark Week for the next, what, year?
Yeah.
Or Lord willing. It's going to be, yeah. There's sharks all around, and they're all little spirits created for vengeance.
Got Amalek right there.
Okay?
Amalek.
Amalek. Are you drinking devil vampire?
Yep. They love that.
Sucking the blood out the baby meat. Yeah, the baby rods.
Baby rods. So.
Pissing at the wailing wall.
Yep. And that's why we're here to tell you.
Homosexual praise in the Holy Land. Yep. Kosher pork.
The Talmud.
I can hump a 3-year-old boy or girl. That's what the Talmud says.
The Talmud also says
that they say, according to their report, the Talmud says the Lord was a sorcerer, man. Mm. And that's what one body in the Yahawashi says that as well.
Oh, yeah, that goes back to the Talmud.
Yep.
This is real quick. Sirach 5 and 7. Make no tearing to turn Yahawashim Rashai, and put not off from day to day, for suddenly shall the wrath of Yahawashim Rashai come forth, and the security. In the security thou shalt be destroyed and perish from the day of vengeance. Okay? And the Lord's the one that's laying on these sore strokes. The death to death, the famine to famine, the captivity to captivity. That's why it's important to what? Make no tearing to the Lord. Seek him right now, as soon as you heard the word. Right?
That's what you brought out, the Iraq going into the spirit of vengeance, right? This is Isaiah 6 and 16. For by fire and by his sword will the Lord plead with all flesh. Yeah, God, this is Isaiah 66 and 15. For behold, Yahweh Hashem Yahushai will come with fire, and with his chariots, and the so-called UFOs, like a whirlwind, to render his anger with fury and his rebuke with flames of fire.
It says the Lord will come with fire, right?
Yep.
This is Luke 12 and 49, and it reads, I have come to send fire on earth, and what will I if it be already kindled? So when the Lord returns, there's already going to be fire upon the earth, you know? And he's going to come with the fathership.
Because right now, the prophets have set this place on fire.
Yeah, spiritual fire.
Because all the words of Hosea 6 and 5, okay, that our words would hew this place, which means cutting down. And right now, the words of a prophet, okay, are being broken. The word of a king is. Let me get there. Yeah, there is power.
Well, the word of a king is there is power. Yeah. Who may say unto them, what doest thou? Who may say unto us, what doest thou? We can paraphrase it. You know?
Because Yaharashai sent the words to his prophets.
You
the prophets
are Jeremiah 1 and 10.
Yaharashai is the head, and the prophets are what his hands that are doing the work. Okay, that he's what set up over the nations.
Wait, precept is 2 Peter 3 and 7. But the heavens and the earth, which are now by the same word, are kept in store, reserved unto fire against the day of judgment and perdition of ungodly men.
Yep.
That backs up Isaiah 66 and 15.
All right. This is Jeremiah chapter 1 and verse 8. It says, be not afraid of their faces, for I am with thee to deliver thee, saith the Lord.
Yep. And that's the same thing that was told to Jacob in Genesis, the 28th chapter. You know, also, Yahawashi, Matthew 28:20, I'm with thee unto the end of the earth. I'm with you always.
Yep.
Even
Ezekiel,
into the earth. Yep.
Ezekiel 3 and 2.
Yep. Beautiful.
Be blunt with people. I saw Ezekiel 21 and 12,
yep,
where it speaks about, you know, slay thy thigh, you know, basically let the people know.
Psalms, the third chapter, yep. I will not be afraid of tens of thousands that camp around against me.
Yeah. Let them know the truth. Don't come with that worldly, soft-ass doctrine where everything's going to be okay.
Nah.
Everything's not going to be okay if you don't have that edge.
Yep.
Okay?
Let's keep it going, brother.
All right, it says, then the Lord will put forth his hand and touch my mouth.
Yep.
And the Lord said unto me, behold.
The same thing that happened with Isaiah in the 6th chapter. And it was an angel that did it. And that's what the Lord does it. He sends angels to give men the understanding by putting his words in their mouth. Keep on going, brother.
Sunday and the Lord's...
Jeremiah 1 and 9.
Jeremiah 1 and 9. Then the Lord put forth his hand and touched my mouth.
And who's the Lord's hand? Yahawashi. You know? And Yahawashi sends the angels, man. Keep on going, brother.
And the Lord said unto me, behold, I have put my words in thy mouth.
I have put my words in thy mouth. Same thing that happened with Isaiah in the 6th chapter. Keep it going, brother.
See, I have this day set thee over the nations.
Over the nations.
And over the kingdoms.
Over the kingdoms.
to root out,
to root out,
and to pull down,
to pull down,
and to destroy,
and to destroy,
and to throw down,
and to throw down,
and to build, and to plant.
Yep, and to build and to plant. Want to get Jeremiah 51 and 22
centuries at the same time. This word is what rooting out from the inside out.
Yep.
Okay, making this what work. Okay, and then what happens? Also, what it's saying to root out to.
And who's it rooting out? I gotta get it.
Yep, Esau, making Esau eat a bear.
Ezekiel 35. I'll start with one. And it reads, moreover, the word of Yahweh Hashem Yahushua came unto me, saying, Son of man, set thy face against Mount Seir and prophesy against him. And that's the report. You know, Esau, Edom, Yahweh Hashem Yahushua, who the world knows is God and Jesus, he's against you. He hates you. Ezekiel 35 and 3, and say unto it, thus saith the Lord Yahweh Hashem Yahushua, behold, O Mount Seir. Now, if you go into this phrase, Mount Seir, it means the occupants, or the people who occupy Mount Seir, which is the children of Edom, the tabernacles of Edom.
Back up on that.
You know, the Edomites.
Genesis 36 and 8. Thus dwelt Esau in Mount Seir.
Yep.
Esau is Edom.
Yep. Go to Genesis 25 and 30, brother.
Genesis 25.
To match Esau with Edom.
Yeah, because Esau is interchangeable with Edom.
Yep.
Okay? And Edom, when you go into the Greek word, it goes into Idumia, which means red. Going back to Cain.
Adawan.
Or Adawan.
But the Greek way of saying Edom is Idumia. Beautiful, brother.
Okay, yeah.
That sounds
okay,
beautiful. Bro.
That's what we hear.
Okay, yeah, you got me.
I may say Romans, you say Revelation. Okay, yeah.
Because ultimately, water, brother, what I wanted to bring out is that it goes back to Cain. Cain being what? Cursed with leprosy, being translucent, showing you that he's the true red man. He's not white. He's not white. Okay, white and black are social constructs and ultimately are bywords that they put on our people to divide us, breaking the bands asunder, to divide us. And the Lord is bringing us back to our heritage, which is what? The language of Canaan, which is what? The ancient Hebrew. Okay?
So it's Genesis 25 and 30.
Yep.
And Esau said to Jacob, feed me, I pray thee, with that same red pottage.
That same red pottage. Yep.
For I am faint.
For I am faint.
Therefore was his name called Edom.
Yep. So we're tying Esau to Edom. And Esau, Edom dwelt in Mount Seir. And the modern day Edomites are still here. And we know them to be the so-called white men.
Real quick. Revelation 6 and 4. And there went out another horse that was red. And power was given him to sat therein to take peace from the earth. And they that should kill one another, and there was given to him a great sword. Going back to what? Genesis 27 and 39, where Isaac, which is Jehoshaphat conceiving, gave Esau, gave him what? That great sword. Gave him the fatness of the earth, which is all the fertile places, the oil, and also what? That great sword, which you see on display. That horse symbolizes the power that he has.
That they should kill one another.
Yep.
That's a sign. That's also a clue of who the Edomites are. What do they do? What do they go around doing? They go around killing people with their sword, their weaponry, their military.
Right now they're fighting Russia against America.
Yep.
Which they're both Edomites. They shall kill each other. You're gonna see these low-level Edomites because they realize the white supremacy doesn't mean anything anymore.
Yep.
That they're out of the plan, they're out of the loop. These elites have cut you white supremacists out of the loop. Okay? You're no more, you get no more Deuteronomy 30 and 7.
The wisdom is being finished.
Yeah, the wisdom is being finished, right?
They should complain of an ungodly father, of an ungodly spiritual father, because the lower level Edomites, the people who are just at the bottom drinking Mountain Dew, you know, drinking Bud Light, smoking American spirits, eating uncooked steaks, you know, the cheap uncooked steaks, you know, the eye of chuck meats.
Yeah, the ones that have the deer, have the deer on their wall, have the rabbits. You know,
they're starting to realize that these niggas right here, they don't give a shit about them, man.
Yeah.
You know? They're starting to feel shysted, man.
Yeah.
You know, like Hunter Biden was calling that dealer, you know, talking about where's the rest of my 8-ball at, man? You know, where's my other 1.47 grams? You know what I'm saying?
Real quick.
On camera. That's how the lower level Edomites are feeling about the Illuminati, man, because they're feeling like they're not getting their right rightful portion, man. They're like, this is my kingdom, where's my portion at? Why I'm at the bottom with these niggas and spigots, man?
Yep.
And these savages, man. That's Deuteronomy 30 and 7. And these curses shall come upon thy enemies and all them that hate thee.
Yep.
You know?
This is Jeremiah 49:7 concerning Edom, thus said the Lord of hosts,
yep.
The host with his armies, is wisdom no more in Teman, and Teman are what the smartest of Esau, Edom, okay? And
the Teman, Germans.
Yeah. Is counsel perished from the prudent? Is their wisdom vanished? Yeah, so is their wisdom vanished as far as their enchantments, their monthly prognosticators, their astrologers? Is it going away? Okay, yeah, the Lord's taking it away. Because why? Because his word is making them bare. This is skipping down to 10. Jeremiah 49:10, I have made Esau bare. And we already brought that out where Esau is interchangeable with Edom.
Yep.
Right? Bare, I uncovered his secret place. Yeah, so we uncovered his slavery. We uncovered his secret plans that he wants to implement the karagma to everybody, that he wants to give everyone the hot sauce, and that he wants to ultimately kill everybody. Because those are two mannerisms of Esau. Either he wants to deceive you with his slick talk, his smooth double tongue, or he wants to kill you. Okay, we brought that out in Revelation 6:4, right?
Isaiah 28:17, to back up on that point, I'll get 16 as well. Therefore, thus said the Lord, Yahweh Shem Yahshai, behold, I lay in Zion, for a foundation, a stone, that's talking about Yahweh Shai, a tri-stone, a precious cornerstone, a sure foundation. He that believeth shall not make haste. That's the point. Judgment will I also lay to the line, and righteousness to the plummet, and the hail shall sweep away the refuge of lies. I'm going to read again. Yep. Isaiah 28:17. Judgment also will I lay to the line, and righteousness to the plummet, and the hail shall sweep away the refuge of lies, and the waters shall overflow the hiding place.
Mm.
Yeah. These rivers of living water, they're starting to overflow the hiding place of Esau, Edom. You know, he's starting to be found out for who he is, man. You got other nations looking at him like, something ain't right about this nigga, man. You know, you got his own people like, man, to hell with those freaking, they call them the Illuminati, you know? The elites.
Technocrats.
And that's what they're supposed to call the elites, you know?
Yep.
Right. I got one right.
Jeremiah 49:10.
What's his name? Alex Jones. The banksters, the Bilderbergs. He's always going off on them, man.
Yep.
You know?
Yeah, and he's nothing but an insider.
Yep.
Because they have what controlled opposition.
And I believe Alex Jones is a Jake because his great-great-grandfather is Native American. That's what he said. He could be Edomite, but oh well, you know?
Well,
either way, he's pissed off.
Yeah, he's not.
He's pissed off.
And he gives good information, too,
yeah,
about exposing these devils.
So does Dabu 7, the other guys,
yep,
as well.
And the Lord,
Richie from Boston.
I believe he's a J2, Dabu 7.
Yeah.
You know, he'd be with the zoot suits and rapping.
He takes pictures with his
yeah.
You know, he got better bars than mocap.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Oh, that's, yeah, I know, I saw the video. Drew. Jeremiah 49:10, I have made Esau bare, I have uncovered his secret places, and it shall not be able to hide himself to see this world. That goes into what, the 2 Thessalonians 2:3. The
yep.
Man of sin being revealed, the son of perdition, he's being revealed of who he is by what? His draconian measures.
His secret places. Obadiah 1:6. How are the things of Esau searched out? How are his hidden things sought up?
Because the Lord has given the vision to the prophets to be able to expose this devil through the scriptures.
Yep.
Right? And also using these alternative networks like Adam Jones.
And also this nigga's telling himself.
Yep. Yeah.
You know?
Words
my own lips testify against thee and
yep.
not I.
Yep.
You know?
Because he's telling what he wants to do. You had Joe Butthead that was speaking about the food shortages, and he was talking about, yeah, we put the sanctions on the other people, but it's also going to be on us. How do you put sanctions on yourself? Why are you selling oil, our oil reserves for America, to the European nations? Come on, man. And this is all being exposed. You're being exposed.
It's
being
pretty sleepy.
Yep. Yeah, sleepy, creepy Joe. Jim Gaudreau, Butthead Joe. And the Lord, and also these other heathen nations are making fun of you, making fun of your regime.
Your fagged out military.
Yeah, your man-on-man, your transformer council
yep.
that you have, your Fruity Pebble
the
council.
Secretary of Health,
okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Yep. The seed is spoiled in his brethren and his neighbors, and he is not. That's going into your money. Your money don't work no more. Your petrodollar is not working over there. Your European dollar is not working anymore. You better have gold or silver. That's what they're telling you. And that the Lord is setting up these BRICS nations to come all up against you. And they're also known as what the carpenters. And what does the carpenters do? It's to cut you down. When you go into the NLT, Zechariah 1 and 19, it goes into the blacksmith. And blacksmith is what? The artificer, right? Tubal King, the artificer, what? The waster to destroy. And they have more missiles than you. They have the hypersonic capability to destroy you. They have a thing called death hand, okay? Where they can, they're already set to hit these different places that you have set up, okay? They have the, we're speaking about the Poseidon. Okay, you have the Poseidon, which is the Shaitan 2. Which is Shaitan 2 can be able to what? Destroy. One of them can destroy all of Texas. Okay, and that Poseidon, which is a torpedo that goes in the water, and what it does is it hit. When it hits the land, it creates the 100 years it won't be inhabited. These are the type of things that Yahweh Shemashai has given the wicked to be able to create, ultimately to destroy his own place.
Back you up going to the blacksmith. Isaiah 54 and 16. Behold, I have created a smith that bloweth the coals in the fire, and that bringeth forth an instrument for his work. And I have created the waster to destroy. Back you up for that.
Bring out the next
one. God, this is verse 17. Isaiah 54 and 17. No weapon that is formed against thee shall prosper. And every tongue that shall rise against thee in judgment, thou shalt condemn. This is the legacy or the heritage of the servants of the Lord, which are the prophets, and their righteousness is of me, saith Yahweh. Isaiah 54 and 17.
You know, and that's what Edomites do. They'll come into your space, and then they'll be off on your face, and then they'll show you an abomination.
They show no respect.
and that's why this place is going to get destroyed. And they're going to get caught up in the said famine. And because why? Because they're going to trust in Esau. They think having tattoos on your body is good. That's not good. Okay, we know that we were in the world and those things, we did those things, right? But we repented for them. We're not going to, if you saw some guys doing that, they had Yaharashai. They had a tattoo of Yaharashai.
There was a guy out there, he had the cut, and he had the Hebrew. He had the Hebrew in his head. You know?
And that's how this world is. Nothing but what? Abominations.
Revelation 11:13.
That's what it was?
Yeah.
I know it's 11.
Yeah. 11:13.
And why would you touch another man?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You're supposed to respect a man's faith. See, that's what Edomites do. Okay?
And that's an example of this place not having no moral.
Yeah.
Honor, no integrity.
No order. The land darkness.
Yep.
Okay? And but Yahawashai is sent forth order because he said, the brother read it right here, Jeremiah 1 and 10, that I'll set you over the nations, but in wisdom. Okay?
We're going to probably get a quick precept because you mentioned darkness and the water.
Tension on the beach
and
in the water.
Let's get to the 10th chapter.
Yep.
It talks about that.
Yep. Lifeguards are looking for Maria Sanchez. Please contact
Job,
your nearest lifeguard.
Chapter 10.
We have your daughter, Paula Sanchez.
Job.
Lifeguards are looking for Maria Saria Sanchez. We have your daughter, Paula Sanchez. Please contact your nearest lifeguard. Thank you.
All right, Job chapter 10, verse 20. Are not my days few? Cease. 21. Sorry, Salakia. All right, before I go whence, I shall not return even to the land of darkness and the shadow of death.
And the land of darkness and the shadow of death. And that can be backed up by Isaiah, the 60th chapter, Psalms, the 23rd chapter.
Isaiah 60 and 2, for behold, the darkness shall
start
over the earth. Isaiah 16 and 1, arise, shine, for the light is come.
That light is this truth.
And the glory of the Lord is rising upon thee.
Yep, upon the prophets.
For behold,
the report that we gave the word to and his name to. You know? Come on, brother.
For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth.
Yep.
And gross darkness the people.
And gross darkness. That's talking about Esau, Edom, his wine, his philosophies. You know? The MOTB structure. You know? The worship of women. Exalted women over men. You know, the push for transsexuality. The push of sex changes, the push of pedophilia, the push for transhumanism, merging man with machine, you know, the push for the MOTB, you know, the push of the do art thou wilt mentality,
which darkness is confusion, which goes back to the obscurity.
Which goes back to Nimrod, man.
Yep.
You know?
And Nimrod goes back to the word rebellion.
Yep.
This place is a marathon.
And that's that darkness.
Marathon, which is double rebellion.
Yep. Double rebellion.
And that goes into the sound of battle is in the air. Yep. And the Lord has laid a trap and a snare. Roughly paraphrasing that for Jeremiah. Because what's the trap and the snare? Them trying to fight Russia. Ultimately, them trying to come up against the prophets. Yeah. That's what right. We need.
And speaking of double rebellion, there was a Jake, I don't know if you've seen on the group chat on IG, that said he married his trans sister.
Wow.
That's double rebellion. That's double rebellion, man.
And,
damn.
Yep, and that's why.
That's actually triple rebellion.
Yeah.
So that's trans, you know, your
oh yeah, because
the tranny, the homosexuality, and then marrying your sister, man.
And who raised it? Okay, who raised those people? What kind of home is that? That, you know, this is the home of Esau, Edom.
Yep.
This is right. The hands of the wicked.
That's because the pick and roll, that's all a product of the pick and roll from the garden 2.0.
Yep.
That's even the serpent.
Yep.
Because most likely, those kids grew up without a father, you know, receiving government assistance or not, they grew up without a father, you know, because that goes back to the curses.
That goes back to no order.
Yeah, and that goes back to no order. Because what's a man do? He establishes order in the house.
Yep. He is that
Because the man is the head.
Yep. He is that person that's supposed to be chastising while the mom what nurse.
Yep. Right. When you have kids raised up in a society where they don't have a man in the household, they don't have a positive male figure to look up to, and they look up to the people who are on TV who are pushing homosexuality, transsexuality, you know, the rainbow gang on them, glorifying it. That's what they do on BET and on the cartoons as well, man. What do you get a result? What's the result of that product? Well, you get what I just mentioned as far as the Jake marrying his brother who turned into a fucking woman, man.
Damn.
You know, who actually didn't turn into a woman because you can't do that, but became a tranny, better yet.
Well, that's why this generation is called Generation Z.
Yep. The last
generation, because that's what Esau, Edom wants. He doesn't want you to have the Bible. He doesn't want you, he wants you to worship his beast system. That's what the Krogma is. It's implementing the digital awe for them to be able to take away your soul, away your V-man too.
Still alive.
Yep, still on. I see the red. Can you bring that out again, brother?
Yep. All right, this is Job chapter 10, verse 22. It says, a land of darkness as darkness itself, and of the shadow of death, without any order, and where the light is as darkness.
Yep. The light is darkness.
And what's no order? The brother brought it out, the brother Osh brought it out, the woman above the man. That's not the order. You go Yahweh Shai, the man who worships Yahweh Shemiah Shai, okay, then the woman, then the children, okay? And that's the order, right? This is Isaiah 9 and 2. The people that walked in darkness, so they walked in confusion. You see a darkness over here. That's why you have the women showing everything they got. They might have a man, but then they're still looking and shopping for the next one. The people that walk in darkness have seen great light. That great light is what this truth. Okay? They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death. And then what does it say in Psalms 23?
Yeah.
This is the valley of shadow of death, which is what a valley is set in a low place. This is a low place as far as your standards. You can marry a robot. You can marry your cat. You can be with your fish. Okay, these sick things, and we laugh about them, okay? But this is the devil.
Well, in California, where we're at, State Bill 145 says an 8-year-old can get humped by 18-year-old.
Wow.
As long as they're within 10 years. You know, so like, for example, you go out to the baseball game, right? You have an 8-year-old cousin, right? You know what I'm saying? According to California state law, an 18-year-old can be groping them in the bathroom, man. You can't say anything about it, man. You know, because it says as long as the child is willing, you know, that can go down, man. That's complete wickedness, man.
And that goes into a pedo jump.
Yep.
Okay, look at your leaders.
And that goes back to ancient Greece and Rome, because that was a practice that they had called pedestry, man.
Yep.
We're not just making these things up. Look it up.
Yep.
And that's how we know that this society is being ran by the modern-day Edomites, man. Because the Greco-Roman Empire, that was ran by Edomites, man. It even backs that up in the book of 1 Maccabees, the third chapter. It identifies the nation of people that Judas Maccabees is going against as the wicked. And then in 1 Maccabees, the 5th chapter, it identifies them as the children of Esau.
Yep.
That's why they took the Apocrypha out of the scriptures, man. Yep. As well as you can track Esau, Edom's lineage back from the Greeks to Haman the Macedonian, back to King Agag, back to Amalek, back to Eliphaz, back to Esau.
Yep.
That's why they took the Apocrypha out of the scriptures, man.
And then the wickedness multiplied on the earth?
One of the reasons they took the Apocrypha out of the scriptures, but yeah.
Okay.
You know?
So, let me read this again. Isaiah 9 and 2. Oh, yeah. So, Hebrews 12 and 16. Esau is profaned outside the temple. That's why he was rejected. Okay? He's been rejected, so he's seeking out through his cardinal measures. Isaiah 9 and 2. The people that walk in darkness have seen great light, and they dwell in the land of the shadow of death. Upon them hath the light shine. And that's been the elect. The elect have the light is shining upon them. The Lord is looking upon his elect. Shining on his men.
Okay.
Yeah. Let's see, Matthew 6 and 23. Yep. But if thine eye be evil, thy whole body shall be.
Start with 22.
Yep.
Keep
that eye single. It says, the light of the body is the eye.
Yep.
If therefore thine eye be single, thy whole body shall be full of light.
Going into this truth.
But if thine eye be evil,
yep,
thy whole body shall be full of darkness. If therefore the light that is in thee be darkness, how great is that darkness?
How great is that darkness, yeah, man? And that's what our people are in the state of. Gross darkness. Yep.
It says, no man can serve two masters.
Beautiful.
For either he will hate the one and love the other, or else he would hold to the one and despise the other. Ye cannot serve Yahweh and Mammon.
Yep. Yeah, Yahweh and Mammon. Mammon goes into what the riches of this world.
Yep.
Okay, so it also speaks about James 1 and 8. A double-minded man is unstable in all his ways.
It also, the scriptures also say, trust not in uncertain riches.
Yep.
You know?
Yeah, because riches are not going to profit you what in the day of wrath. Okay, you're not going to sit there and have, oh, I have my Bentley. Oh, I have my Hellcat. I got my stick. You know, I got my stick in my Hellcat, and now everything's good. No, you got to have that hedge of protection, that garment, that spiritual garment to keep you from, you know, from being naked out here. Okay?
This is,
This is
Revelation 3 and 15, I'm going to read down to 17. I know thy works, that thou art neither cold nor hot. I would that thou wert cold or hot, being yea or nay, as far as for this truth. Revelation 3 and 16, and it reads, So because thou art lukewarm and neither cold nor hot, I will spew thee out of thy mouth, being a castaway, being a reprobate.
Yep.
We see that we through the luxury of being able to be a participant, you know, in the ministry, we've been able to see that. So we're certain guys, man. You know,
yep,
bugging out, knocking and scoffing, calling the apostles, the house of Saul, so on and so forth.
And that goes into being fervent in the spirit.
Yep.
Because if you're not fervent in the spirit, that means doing the work, the Lord's going to spew you out. That means he's going to hit you with that darkness.
That goes into idle hands.
Yep.
Idle hands are the devil's playground. I'm paraphrasing. You know, this is Revelation 3 and 17, and it reads, so because thou sayest, I am rich, rich in earthly riches. But let's keep reading. Because thou sayest, I am rich and increased with goods and have need of nothing, and knowest not that thou art wretched and miserable, going into you not having the comforter, you being discomfortable. You know, because the comforter is the word, also the spirit. What's the opposite slakia of being comforted or comfort? Being miserable, being wretched, you not having the spirit. These are all parables or dark sayings for not having the spirit in the latter part of this verse. Revelation 3 and 17. Because thou sayest, I am rich and increased with goods and have need of nothing, and knowest not that thou art wretched and miserable, not having the comforter, and poor, you having no spiritual bank account, and blind, you not having the eye salve, and naked, you not having the garment.
That goes into the parable of the money. When,
yep,
when the Lord gave what the money, and then you what
talents?
Your talents, and then you what hid it in a napkin, and then when he came back, you didn't have it. I just gave you back
the same
thing.
You didn't show any increase.
Yeah, you didn't show any increase because as the men of the Lord, you should be what increasing in what you're increasing in the riches, increasing what the fruits of the labor. Because the Lord, if he It also speaks about Revelation 3:20, the Lord's supper with you, being intimate. Real quick, this is Ecclesiastes 4:1. So I returned and considered all the oppressions that are done under the sun, and behold, the tares such as were oppressed, they had no comforter. On the side of their oppressors that there was power, but they had no comforter. Again, that goes to the 2/3 of our people, and that also goes to the people that are going to be spewed out. Okay, that are going to be spewed out because you're not doing the Lord's work. You're not using that money. Okay, you're not increasing in the money. You're not investing in the stock, which is what immortality and salvation, the kingdom. Real quick, Matthew 4 and this is 16. The people which sat in darkness saw a great light. And this is speaking about the elect. Okay? The darkness is the confusion being in this world, right? That light is the truth. And to them which sat in the region in the shadow of death, the light is sprung. So the truth has sprung up what out of gross darkness, out of the valley of shadow of death. Okay? It says 17, for the time Yaharashai began to preach and to say, repent, for the kingdom is at hand. So as soon as the Lord said that, right, the kingdom was at hand. That's when the prophets were set amongst what to teach to the lost sheep. Okay,
that's the setting up of the ministry, right?
Yep. And that's the setting up of that council that shall stand. The tabernacle of David, the first fruits, the Alahayim, which are the powers, right? Okay, we're praying that we're of that that number, right?
I got a Christmas back you up, going into public riches. This is James 5:1. Go to now ye rich men, weep in hell, for your misery shall come upon you. Like I said to Esau, Esau is going to that.
And that's the spirit. You hear what's playing in the background? Don't walk away.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Your riches are corrupted, and your garments are molten. Your gold and silver is cankered, and the rust of them shall be a witness against you.
Yep. And the riches are not moth-ridden, okay, but how they got them. They're rape, robbing, murdering, through deceit and deception, right?
It says, James 5:3, your gold and silver is cankered, and the rust of them shall be a witness against you, and shall eat flesh as they were fired. Ye have heaped treasure together for the last days.
Yep. So those treasures are actually going to be the evidence of what you've done.
Yep.
That Wisdom of Solomon 1:9, where it speaks about that great inquisition, this is the evidence. And we're showing forth what the evidence through testifying and making a strong case of, first of all, who the wicked is and all the things you have done by what? Your own history.
Yep. Okay? Real quick, a precept to back you up on that point you were just bringing out. Sirach 14:4, and it reads, he that gathereth by defrauding his own soul gathereth for others, that shall spend his goods riotously. You know? Because you gathered, you know, defrauding your own soul, defrauding your own people, and, you know, selling out, and you give it to Esau, Edom, as far as, you know, you're gathering and you're selling out to Esau, Edom, and what's Esau, Edom going to do? You know, he's going to push more wickedness in the earth, man.
He's going to spew you out, too.
Yeah.
Because he don't give a fuck about you.
Yeah, right.
He has a perpetual hatred. That means everlasting. That goes back to the womb.
Yep.
Jacob and Esau.
This is Sirach 14:6, and it reads, there is none worse than he that envieth himself, and this is a recompense of his wickedness. You know,
Psalms 37 and verse 34. It says, wait on the Lord and keep his way. He shall exalt thee to inherit the land. When the wicked are cut off, thou shalt see it. I have seen the wicked in great power and spreading himself like the Green Bay tree. Yep. You know, because he has to cover the light, like how a tree, you know, covers the sun for the light. You know, he has to cover, the wicked have to cover.
The shadow.
Yeah.
The shadow, okay? Covering up what all the wickedness that he's done. But now what this word is making is what, man, you can't hide no more. Okay? And that Green Bay tree also goes into him enlarging his place as hell, going and being in other people's business in all these different countries, okay? And that's the same thing that happened in Rome. Okay, which is this is Rome 2.0, that they were made bare. Their military is in all these different places. Meanwhile, what, this place is going to get sank, you know, going to get spoiled, according to Nahum 3:1, according to Isaiah 13, which speaks about the Medes will come, or Ezekiel 38, the Medes will come and spoil this place.
Okay. Wait, precept, Isaiah 47:2, take the millstones and grind mill, uncover thy locks, make bare the leg, uncovereth the thigh, pass over the rivers. We'll start at 1. Isaiah 47 and 1.
Yeah, because you're not going to have no throne, Esau, Edom. This is the last time that the kingdom is being translated because of your unrighteous dealing, which is got by the sea.
And 3 is understanding, because Esau ruled during the Grecian Empire, Roman Empire, and this is the modern day Babylonian Empire.
And now we understand who the devil is, and he's being put down by this word.
Isaiah 47 and 1, and the title reads, Judgment upon Babylon. It says, come down and sit in the dust, O virgin daughter of Babylon. And the reason why Esau, Edom, he's known as the virgin daughter of Babylon is because he's never been touched. Yep. Like normal.
Yeah, he hasn't lost in war. Okay? He hasn't lost in none of the wars that he's been in. He's been unscathed. That's why it's the virgin daughter.
Also, nobody's ever hit a bomb on mainland America, you know? America has never had anybody invade them, you know?
Right.
They've always been the one that's doing the invading.
Yeah, they always had, been the bully.
You had the British-American wars, but that wasn't a major conflict, you know?
Well, that was Esau against Esau.
That was Esau against
that
Esau.
That was the 17th.
French-American wars as well, you know? Yeah. But that wasn't like a major conflict where, you know, cities were bombed, cities were destroyed. You just had a whole bunch of Edomites die in the field, you know, waging war against each other, clashing swords and not, man. You know, shooting muskets at each other, man. But what we're talking about is when cities are destroyed, man. You know? And Babylon the Great is destroyed. I had that priest up earlier. I'm going to get it real quick since we're bringing it up. Revelation 11 to 13, and it reads, in the same hour there was a great earthquake, and the 10th part of the city fell. Talking about the 10 FEMA regions, you know, talking about America as a whole, because America is divided into 10 FEMA regions, 10 FEMA zones. That's the 10th part of the city. In the same hour there was a great earthquake going into the nuclear destruction. The earth shall reel to and fro like a drunkard. Yep, that's in Isaiah the 24th chapter, I believe. Yep. And the same hour there was a great earthquake, and the 10th part of the city fell, and in the earthquake were slain of men 7,000, going into a complete number of men amongst the 300-some million men that are in Babylon the Great. 300 million plus people, better yet, you know? Because you're gonna have women and children die, you know?
Real quick, Isaiah 9 and 5, for every battle of warrior was a confused noise and garments rolled in blood. So again, going into when they were talking about the civil wars, they were fought with what? With their swords, you know, hand-to-hand battle. You would have also your king go out there and fight, like King David, okay? But now it's what? With that wasted to destroy. But this shall be with burning fuel and fire.
Yep.
So going into the missiles. Okay?
What's that word fuel doing in the Old Testament? Think about that. You know what I'm saying?
At that time.
Yep. They didn't have fuel at that time.
And that shows you that what the Daniel 12 and 4, that the knowledge shall be increased.
Yep.
Okay.
This is Revelation 11 and 13. In the same hour, there was a great earthquake, and the 10th part of the city fell. And in the earthquake were slain of men 7,000. And the remnant were affrighted and gave glory unto the power of heaven. The second woe is past, and behold, the third woe coming quickly.
And that's where we're headed to right now, which is going to be what that waste is to destroy. Hypersonic missiles, right? Isaiah 24 and 19, the earth is utterly broken down. The earth is clean and dissolved. The earth is moved exceedingly. The earth shall reel to and fro like
a
drunkard.
That's going into that earthquake. Yep. That's being talked about in the book of Revelation, the 11th chapter.
It says, it shall be removed like a cottage, and the transgression thereof shall be heavy upon thee, and it shall fall and not rise again.
Yep.
Okay?
Also, the scriptures talk about there being a line of confusion in the form of, you're not going to know what's LA from Milwaukee, from Chicago, because this whole place is going to be obliterated.
Yep.
For the wickedness that this place perpetuates, man.
Jeremiah 51 and 7, Babylon hath been a golden cup, and Yahweh Shemashai's hand that made all the earth drunken. The nations have drunken of the wine, therefore the nations are mad.
Want to start from the top? 51.
Jeremiah 51, thus said Yahweh Shemashai, behold, I will raise up against Babylon and against him that dwell in the midst of them that rise against me, a destroying wind.
A destroying wind, that's talking about the ICBM missiles, man. Babylon the Great, you know, because ancient Babylon wasn't destroyed by a destroying wind, you know. The Medes and the Persians came in, man, you know. It talks about that in the book of Daniel, the 5th chapter, you know, because Belshazzar, the son of Nebuchadnezzar, was drinking out of the fixtures from the temple, you know. And what happened? That hand put the writing on the wall and said, nah, bro, it's over, man. Many tekel apersim.
And it also happened in Zur. It was like 4 or 5 years ago. When they went to go through, that same thing came upon the wall. Showing you forth the judgment.
To the modern day Babylon.
Yep. And showing that written for our forefathers.
That's how cold Yehovah Hashem Yahshua is, man.
Yep.
This thing is deep. We got to get into it like the apostle said, man.
And you got to be able to, cross the bar says, you got to see the vision. You got to visualize the destruction.
When you read the scriptures, you got to be able to close your mind and see the movie, man.
Yep.
This is the greatest movie ever written, man.
And what's the reward? The kingdom. And also seeing the kingdom. Real quick, let me skip over to Jeremiah 50. And
also reward is having your name written in the second book of Acts, man.
Being called a faithful servant.
Because the second book of Acts is being written right now. You know, through men doing the work, man.
Yep. So let me skip over it. I'm going to go back to 51, but I want to go to Jeremiah 50. And 22, a sound of battle is in the land of great destruction. Yep. So the sound of battle is over here. What, you have Russia telling Russia, Vladimir Putin, saying if they want to battle, he said, let's see. Okay. Then you have Xi Jinping saying what?
That's me in the streets.
See if you can deal with Satan too beside it, right? Xi Jinping said, meet in the air.
Come outside, catch
his face. Yeah, let's meet in the air. Rocket Man over there in North Korea, he said he's already shooting off his shit. He's not even letting people know. He's just shooting off. Keep your home, And then also China, they just shot a hypersonic missile that went around the world, and I think it was like maybe like 1,000 feet off or something like that, showing you the increase of this technology.
Yep.
Okay, the sound of battle is in the land of great destruction.
That's the sword being sharpened for the sword.
Yep, being furbished. Right? It says, how is the hammer of the whole earth cut asunder and broken? Yep. How has Babylon become desolation among the nations?
Yep.
So that hammer goes into what their military force, because they were hammering, beating everybody to a pulp with their military. Okay? And what? The cutting asunder. They don't have hypersonic missiles. China has them. Russia has them. They don't have those missiles.
That's let the weak say I'm strong.
Yep. And they're saying they're strong. Why?
Because you have the other nations who are not military superpowers sticking up their chest like, yeah, what's up now?
Yep.
What's up now?
Yep.
What's up now? Yeah. Because guess what? They got the big homies backing them up.
Yeah, yeah, that's like
they got Russia and China.
Yeah, that's like the bully on the block. You know, one dude, he gets locked up. Whenever you don't see him, then he comes back. He's all small.
Yeah.
And now he's come back. Yep. He's come back for vengeance. Okay? And that's Yahweh Shai, actually. Okay, Yahweh Shai is coming back. Well, for vengeance, Matthew 10 and 34, he's coming with that great sword.
Well, to bring another carnal example of that, what happened in the 80s, man, you had a lot of dudes in the early 90s. What happened? You had a lot of dudes who weren't, you know, big muscle boys out in the streets. And then what happened? The crack game came in, and they were allowed to be, you know, major forces in the hood, man, because they had drug money backing them up. They could, and then you had the guns coming in.
Guns,
and they couldn't fight with a lick, but now they're the biggest man on the block. They're the biggest, baddest man on the block. Even though this dude is 5'6", 140 pounds soaking wet, he can't fight with a lick. But this dude got all the money in the hood, and he got all the weaponry, man.
And that's what you saw either, because the Lord has given them that portion to have that sword. Okay, because really, they're not stronger than us.
Yep.
They're not smarter than us. They're not, there's nothing. When you look at, even at our lowest state, they can't, they have no style, they can't cook, okay? But the Lord has given them the portion, right?
Let's back up on that. Daniel 4:17, this matter is by the decree of the watchers and the demand by the word of the holy ones, to be intent that the living may know that the Most High ruleth in the kingdom of man, and giveth it to whomsoever he will, and setteth up over it the basis of man.
Right. Basis of it, and it's 1 Samuel, what is that, 2:6, that he can raise up who he wants. Okay, and right now he's raising up what, the tabernacle
of David. Okay. It talks about them being the base men in Job, the 30th chapter.
Yep, the vilest men.
Yep, they're violent in the earth. Yep. They're children of fools, children of base men.
Job wouldn't have them lay with the dogs because they would have sex with the dogs.
Yep.
And that's what you saw here, profane and outside the temple.
I got this right here. This is Job chapter 5 and verse 10. It says, who giveth rain upon the earth and sendeth waters upon the fields. That's Yehovah Hashem Yahshua giving us the understanding, the waters, you know, to cast down this kingdom, to set up on high those that be low, and that those which mourn may be exalted to safety. He disappointed the devices of the crafty, so that their hands cannot perform their enterprise. You see, so right when Esau, when he thinks he's going forward, the Lord is setting him up for a trick bag. You know, the vessel's fitted for destruction.
You want to get 5:11 again, real quick?
This is Jeremiah 15:24. I have laid 11. A snare for thee, and thou art also taken, O Babylon, and thou waste not away. They are found and also caught, because thou hast striven against Yahweh Shemashai. The Lord Yahweh Shemashai had opened his armory, and had brought forth his weapons of indignation for this work of Yahweh Shemashai, of hosts, of armies in the land of the Chaldees. Come against her from uttermost border, open her storehouses, cast her up as heaps, and destroy her utterly, let nothing of her be left. Going into the total destruction, the annihilation of Babylon the Great, and you know, the motherland Jerusalem, and other parts of the world. Okay? And the armory is what? These military, Iran, Taiwan, all these different nations, China, all these different nations, that's the armory of Yahweh Shemashai.
It tests that as a law, Yahweh was the man of the Lord.
All right, this is Job chapter 5, verse 11. It says, to set up on high those that be low.
To set up on high those that be low. And that's what he's doing right now through men coming out preaching the gospel, man.
That those which mourn may be exalted to safety.
That those which mourn may be exalted to safety.
Want to get Isaiah 61st chapter?
Yep.
The
third
verse.
Let me get Ezekiel 17:24. And it reads, and all the trees of the field, and trees is nations. And all the trees of the field shall know that I, the Lord, have brought down the high tree. That's Esau, Edom. The brother brought out Psalms where it says, I have seen the wicked spreading like a Green Bay tree. I think it's 37 and 35.
Right.
I have seen the wicked in great power and spreading himself like a Green Bay tree. That's talking about Esau, Edom. And Mark 8:24 refers to nations as being trees. Also, Ezekiel 17:24, and all the trees of the field shall know that I, the Lord, have brought down the high tree, have exalted the low tree, have brought up the green tree, and have made the dry tree to flourish. I, the Lord, Yahweh Shemashai, have done it. And that dry tree that's flourishing is the tabernacle of David, man. You know, the house of David, man. You know? The dry bones, the valley of dry bones, you know, who've been given the breath, the sinews, the flesh, and, you know, the spirit, man.
And that water, which is this word, you're able to maneuver through whatever that you got to go through, whatever adversity.
Yep.
Okay? So you're able to go in every single place, right? That's why what this water is, Habakkuk 2:14, is what comes from the earth, okay, and of the sea. The sea are also known as the people, okay?
Yep.
Even if you have these low... These celebrities, okay, they know that they're Israelites, but they're not hearkening to the Lord, right?
This is a quick precept to back you up on the waters, and it reads, Proverbs 5:16, drink waters out of thy own cisterns, and running waters out of thine own well.
Own, out of your own, that means your own, that means your heritage, that means men that are like you, okay, out of what, starting with the head apostles, the great apostles.
Men with like-minded doctrine.
Yeah, like-minded doctrine.
You know,
not going in every wind, not tossing to and fro in every wind and doctrine.
Proverbs 5:16, drink waters out of thine own cistern, and running waters out of thine own well. He that believeth on me, as the scripture said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water, running water.
Yep.
This
that
is
goes into gushing
yep.
down, right?
The understanding.
Yep.
You know? Proverbs 5:16, let thy fountains be dispersed abroad, and rivers of waters in the streets. Let's get Zechariah 13:1. Real quick. Are you ready? In that day, there should be a fountain open into the house of David, and into the inhabitants of Jerusalem for sin and for uncleanness. I'm gonna read it again. This is Zechariah 13:1. In that day, there shall be a fountain opened into the house of David and to the inhabitants of Jerusalem for sin and for uncleanness. And that fountain is the rivers of living water. Yahweh Shai, you know? He's the only one that can pardon your sins, man. You know? who's in Yahushua's in the law. You know, Deuteronomy the 18th chapter. I will raise a prophet from among thy brethren. Exodus 23 and 20. Behold, I send an angel before thee to keep thee in the way. I am the way, the truth, and the life. John 14 and 6. Second, can't get around Yahushua, you know. No man cometh to the Father except through me.
I'm in the volume of the book. Yeah. It's in Hebrews and also in Psalms. Psalms 40 and 7.
The intercessor, Hebrews. The mediator. Yep. Isaiah the 53rd chapter.
Yeah, because who's that intercessor? Okay. This is 2 Ezra 6 and 27. For evil shall be put out and the sea shall be quenched. Yeah, it's being quenched by what? This word.
These rivers are living water.
Yep. 28, as for faith, it shall flourish, corruption shall be overcome, and the truth which hath been so long without fruit shall be declared. And those fruits goes into what that great blessing.
And 2nd Ezra 5th chapter, the brother brought it out earlier, said the way of truth shall be hidden.
Yep. No? And because we have what, drink the cup of what, of slavery, okay, these devils are going to also drink of that cup, right?
As you were mentioning LeBron, what song is playing in the background? I want to be down. Yes. If you have a lot of these celebrities, they want to be down. But they're afraid to fully commit themselves, going into losing their place.
Yep.
You know, John 11 and 47 and 48, yep. The Romans shall come and take our place.
Yep.
You know, I just get it real quick.
Those are the wicked Pharisees. They didn't want to. That's why they didn't like Yahushua, because they felt Yahushua was going to take their place.
And he was taking their money.
Yep.
Because a lot of those guys, they were getting a lot of money from just pacifying Israel, man. You know? Yep. And you have those guys coming back doing exactly that all over again, man. You can take the MOTB. You can take the implantable chip. It's all good. You can repent from it. That's the report of WFI. That's the report of HOI. Those are doctrines of devils, man. You know?
Yep. And through these waters, through this truth, what one kingdom is being put down, another kingdom is being put up, which is the kingdom of Yahushua.
Esau, Edom is starting to be exposed, and new false prophets are being exposed, man.
Real quick, this is Psalm 76, no, it's like Psalm 75 and 7. When Yahweh is the judge, he puffeth out one and set up another, showing you there's not going to be, what, two rulerships. Okay, it's like it. There's not going to be two kings. Okay, there's only going to be one king, and that's King of Kings, Lord of Lords, which is our Lord Yahushua, our Savior. Okay, and the elect are going to be joint heirs. 8, for in the hand of Yahweh my side, there is a cup, and wine is red. It is full of mixture, and poureth out the same, but the dregs thereof are all the wicked of the earth, shall wring them out and drink them. But I will declare forever, I will sing praises to Yahweh Bashimashai of Jacob. All the horns of the wicked, and the horns goes into their power, the horns of the wicked also will cut off, but the horns of the righteous shall be exalted.
So, this is, this is John 11. This is John 11. I'm going to start with 45. Then meaning the Jews, which came to Mary and had seen the things which Yahushua did, believed on him. But some of them went their ways to the Pharisees and told them the things Yahushua had done. Snitching.
And that's what two-thirds of our people are going to do.
Yep.
They're going to say, hey, look at them, look at what they're doing.
Yep.
You know what I mean? That's why it's important to not carry sticks to camp.
Yep.
Okay.
Got distracted, huh? John 11 and 47. Then gathered the chief priests and the Pharisees a council and said, what do we, for this man doeth many miracles? So they knew about the miracles, and they were still, the spirit was still put on them to not believe, to scoff and mock, and to try to put him to death. You know, this chapter right here, if you read the footnote, it says a plan to kill Yahushua. The plan to kill Yahushua. That's what it says right here. You know? And you want to get John 15 and 20, brother? This is John 11 and 48, and it reads, if we let him thus alone, all men will believe on him, and the Romans shall come and take away both our place and nation. So he had sellout, sucker MCs, you know, I'll just keep it 100, bitch-ass niggas, you know, in the spot of the priesthood, who are scared to stand upon the doctrine, who are afraid of the power of Yahushua, who knew about the miracles and didn't want to believe, who are planning to put him to death, man.
Belly, I'll drop a dime on him.
Yep.
The dude eating bananas.
Yeah, Rico's.
Yeah, Rico.
You know? And that's spiritual, though, because what are they going to look to hit us with? Rico, you know, terrorists, you know, domestic terrorists.
Well, that's
you know,
what Project Mosquito is all about.
They're gonna blame certain brothers and say that we ran drug rings. They were trying to do that in Chicago.
Yeah, with Benji.
Yeah, with the brother, you know? Yeah. Trying to say that there was a brother in the camp who was a ringleader. Yeah. They were distributing drugs, trying to hit him with a RICO charge, man. Yeah. You know? And who was doing
it?
Which was all BS. And who was doing it? There's probably some sucker MC in that camp or affiliated or coming up to the camp, you know? Who was a RICO, man? You know? I don't like that shit. You know, shit? Let's keep it going, bro.
All right, I got John 15, verse 20. It says, remember the word that I said unto you.
Yep.
The servant is not greater than his Lord.
The servant is not greater than his Lord.
If they have persecuted me, they will also persecute you.
Yep.
If they have kept my saying, they will keep yours also.
And that gives us comfort. When we see people coming up, mocking, scoffing, people come against us, you know, people with that just blatant hatred that they have, you know, that goes into the hatred that they have for the prophets, man. They were trying to kill Jeremiah. They, you know, they threw him in jail for a little while in the pit. You know, they were trying to kill Elijah, you know. They sought to kill and did kill a lot of the apostles, man. You know, and Salaki, I did a lesson on it, and I said that Timothy was beheaded. He wasn't beheaded, Salaki. Sometimes
John the Baptist
was beheaded. Paul was beheaded. Judas, he was actually put to death with an axe, you know?
Yeah.
And then if you go into Timothy was stoned because he went to try to intercess the Jakes worshiping Diana, you know, Diana of Ephesus. That reminds me of Acts the 19th chapter. And those wicked-ass Jakes dragged him out of the city, beat him up, and they stoned him, man.
Damn.
Same thing that happened to Paul,
yeah.
You know, in the Acts of the 14th chapter, man.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking about.
And
yeah,
what happened to Stephen? Stephen was cutting them niggas, and they stoned him as well, man.
Yeah. Same chapter.
You know?
Yeah. So real quick, this is Jerry.
Yeah, and it goes into Yahawashai, you know, are you ready to drink of the cup? Yeah. You shall surely drink of the cup, man.
Which means catching hell.
Yeah, catching hell, man.
Yep. This is real quick, Matthew's 5. And
Salaki, if you watch that lesson, you know, sometimes you get a little excited. Sometimes we do mix things up and we slip up with the tongue.
Matthew 5 and 10. Blessed are which are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for there is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are ye when men shall revile you and persecute you, and you shall all manner of evil against you falsely for my sake. Rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven, for so persecuted the prophets which were before you. So again, it's a blessing to be persecuted for the truth, because that means you're standing on something. And the world is going to hate you, like the brothers brought up. The world's going to hate you because they despise all you.
First Peter.
Was that Matthew 5 and 10?
Yep.
This is James 5 and 10. Take my brethren, the prophets, who have spoken in the name of the Lord Yahweh Shel Shai, for an example of suffering, affliction, and patience.
Yep. And that's all.
Yeah, spoken in the name. Also in the name. Also in his rank and in his authority, because he gave authority to his men, you know? I'll get that in John, the 20th chapter.
And patience goes with the long-suffering. Our Lord is long-suffering. And you are not at all what?
To quit the wicked.
Yeah. Not at all to quit the wicked, but also to reach your labors in vain.
Yep.
Yeah, anything that you've done in this truth, as long as you kept being consistent and being fervent,
acts
and being bound. Yeah, your acts follow you. But once you put the plow down, then there's no more. There's no more, okay?
Yeah,
that's why, and being great, just real quick, in the world, in a sense of being great, is being consistent.
Yep.
Okay, being consistent. That's why these, Jordan, Kobe, they were consistently great. Why? Because they practiced, they studied.
They speak about working on their craft.
Yeah, they're working on their craft. Yeah. They were never satisfied with just...
They were locked in.
Yeah, they were locked in. And that's how we're supposed to be in, is locked into the spirit. Locked into that Ruach HaKodesh, okay, that Holy Spirit, locked into Yahweh Shai, knowing that the days are evil, being wise, being circumspect. Okay,
edify or be edified daily. That was a good lesson put up by Elder Thompson Wong.
Yep.
You know? Because, you know, you may come into this thing and you may not have the spirit or measure to put on a lesson every day, which you should try to do. But at the same time, hey, if you're not putting on a lesson, watch a good 3 or 4. You know, read twice as much as you did the other day you didn't put out the lesson, you know?
Because
study more, you know, pray, fast.
Because also, Yahara Shai taught daily in the temple.
Yep.
Even the Sabbath, okay? So if we're trying to be like Yahara Shai, everyone has their certain measure. okay? But the thing is, you should try, when you think about being okay, if the Lord is...
The apostles taught in the temple daily.
Yep. And if I think about
Acts the second chapter, the last verse. Great,
they're consistently working on their craft, yep. Which is what the ministry, constantly working, reading the soul that self-improved. Okay, you might not be doing lessons every single day, but you're thinking about a lesson. You're occupied in psalms and hymns as far as the things that are going on in the world, because everything's going on right now. You know what I'm saying? And again, I keep saying that to sup. When the Lord's supping with you, he's being intimate. That means he's constantly bringing forth scriptures.
Pouring water on you.
Yeah, pouring water on you, right?
Brother had a precept real quick.
I got a 1 Peter chapter 1 and verse 6. It says, wherein ye greatly rejoice, though now for a season, if need be, ye are in heaviness through manifold temptations, that the trial of your faith, being much more precious than of gold that perisheth, though it be tried with fire, might it be found unto praise and honor and glory at the appearing of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai.
Yep. And I'll just get a precept that backs it up. This is, this is 2nd Ezra 13, 16 chapter. 2nd Ezra 16.
Right, 2 and 5, it says, for gold is tried in the fire, and acceptable men,
through what? Through the trial of your faith.
In the furnace of adversity.
You know, now the three holy children, Hananiah, Azariah, and Mishael, had to go through it, you know? That's Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. The Hebrew names is Azariah, Hananiah, and Mishael. You know, they had to go through the actual physical, you know, furnace of affliction, man. And who was there to bring them out of it? Yahweh Shah.
Yep.
You know?
And the fire.
This
right
is...
Verse 3, I got one more for slide. Job 23 and 10.
Yep.
But he knoweth the way that I take.
I shall come forth as gold.
When he has tried me,
yep.
I shall come forth as gold.
Yep.
Well, just to back you up on that, going through adversity, that's what's going to make you better, man. I'm a better man of the Lord, for sure.
Which you should be striving to do every day, man. Strive for the masters, you know? This is 2nd Ezra 16 and 73, and it reads, then shall they be known who are my chosen, and they shall be tried as the gold in the fire. You want to get Revelation 3 and 18?
Real quick, just to add on to that, keep going. It says, here, O my, it's 2nd Ezra 16, 74.
Yep.
Here, O my beloved, said
going into the house of David.
Yep. Here, O my beloved, yeah, so,
yep. You know, beloved, that's what David was.
Okay, yeah, kind of. I was trying to think of the Hebrew word of beloved.
The one, the one.
The one. Okay. Yeah, the one. So that's what King David, because the tabernacle of David is being risen up. Okay? We're out that number, right? Here, O beloved, said Yahweh Shimon, behold, the days of trouble are at hand, but I will deliver you from the same.
He didn't say the whole nation of Israel. He said the beloved, man.
Yeah.
The house of David, man. Those who are able to hear. Those who Yahweh Shai prayed for, going back to John the 17th chapter. Those who he sent and gave his word to, and gave his name to.
The secret.
And then those that believed on the report through their preaching.
Yep. And those that hid themselves in the refuge, those that, what Psalms 91, where it speaks about those that called upon my name. It's Psalms 91 and 14. Okay, I'll hide you, preserve you.
No, right, I'll back you up because it's so interesting. The book of Baruch says, we're going to be loved the heavenly Lord is.
Yep.
Real quick, I'll get this to Baruch 3 and 36. Yahweh has found all the way of knowledge, and has given it unto Jacob his servant, and to Israel his beloved. So it's back to that. The beloved that's speaking about the nation of Israel. So whenever you encounter the letters of Apostle Paul, speaking to the beloved that's speaking about the house of David.
2nd Ezra 16 to 70, slack in 75. But yeah, so delivering the days of trouble, okay? Jacob's trouble, the hour of temptation, okay? It says 75, be ye not afraid, neither doubt, for Yahweh is your guide. Okay, and the Lord is guiding us through what that precepts like understanding, what is what a lamp unto our feet,
yep.
To guide us in what to that perfect day. Roughly paraphrasing, those are two scriptures mixed together. But the thing is that this light will guide you down that out of darkness, right?
I'll skip John 20. We'll close out with Revelation, the third chapter.
All right, this is Revelation chapter 3, verse 18.
Go down all the way, get all the meat, all the way to the ends, brother.
All right. It says, I counsel thee to buy of me gold tried in the fire, that thou mayest be rich, and white raiment, that thou mayest be clothed, and the shame of thy nakedness do not appear. And anoint thine eyes with eye salve, that thou mayest see.
That goes into being given the understanding, because you have two-thirds of our people, they're blinded from the foundations of the earth, going back to Isaiah the 6th chapter. You know, and right before, it mentioned those being blinded, it mentioned Isaiah given, being given the understanding.
Even back straight, to Genesis.
Straight from the angels.
Yep, Genesis 3 and 24.
Yep.
Blinded him from what, the tree of life?
Yep.
Okay. The cherubim, the angels that blinded him from the ultimately the tree.
Says as many.
And Adam, he was given the breath of life.
Yep.
You know,
which were oracles.
Yep. Which okay. is oracle, which is oral commandments.
Yep.
Who were then passed down unto his descendants. Man, that's how Abel knew what to sacrifice.
Which Adam was what Yahweh shot.
Yep.
Okay.
It says, as many as I love, I rebuke and chasten.
Despise the chastening of the Lord, man. You know, he chastens those who he loves, and he chastens his sons.
Be zealous.
You gotta go through it to get to it.
Be zealous, therefore, and repent.
Yep, be zealous, therefore, and repent. Be hot.
Behold, I stand at the door and knock.
Stand at the door of your mind.
If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come in to him and will sup with him, and he with me.
Beautiful, because I've been quoting that the whole day, and that's the spirit. Okay, the door is Yahweh Shai. Yahweh Shai sends the Alahayim, again, the angels, to be able to work on your mind. That's brought out in Job 33 and 15. Okay, and that word sub, when you go into the definition, it goes into be intimate. The Lord is intimately dealing with you. He's dealing with every brother personally and using other brothers to be able to bring out these epistles to be able to give you comfort. Because that's how you're comforted in what the secret place is, which is what? This truth. This is the only thing that can be able to save you from the destruction that's about to happen.
I mentioned it earlier. Let me get it. We'll finish out with that. 2nd Esdras 14 and 41. And my mouth was open and shut no more. The highest gave understanding unto five men. They wrote the wonderful visions of the night that were told, which they knew not. And they sat 40 days, and they wrote in the day, and at night they ate bread. Going into, after the temple was destroyed, Ezra was given the oracles, you know, so he can recite it to the five men who wrote all the visions down. Because they didn't have any records in the temple after the Babylonians sacked, you know, after the Babylonians sacked it, man. You know, going into the Persian Mede captivity, you know? Because Ezra was around before the Babylonians going into the Persian Mede captivity. After the temple was destroyed. This is going into that. As for me, I spake in the day, and I held not my tongue at night. And 40 days they wrote 204 books. And it came to pass when the 40 days were fulfilled that the highest spake, saying, the first that thou hast written, publish openly, which is what we're doing. We're publishing the word openly in the marketplace, man.
You know? 13, published,
and conceal not. There's thousands of people out here, man. You know? Thousands of people out here, you know?
Yeah. Publicly and, standing on what? This word, this foundation, that rock. That
oh, yeah.
Rejected
that, that's how you know it's wartime. You hear that? You smell that chronic.
Yeah, that's the beginning of the
game. Yes, the beginning and the end of the game session.
Yeah, the smoke.
This is 2nd Esdras 14 and 45. And it came to pass when the 40 days were fulfilled that the highest spake, saying, the first that thou hast written, published openly, that the worthy and the unworthy may read it. But the 70 last, that thou mayest deliver them only to such as be wise among the people, those that believe. You know, that's what we're supposed to go out here and preach the word to, you know, and to edify those that believe, man. Those that don't believe, you know, to hell with it, man.
Yep.
Pray not for these people, throw up curses on them, man.
Matthew 7:5, preach to the lost sheep and tell them that the kingdom is at hand.
That is just, but if
you're just, that doesn't, yeah, why you're gonna.
If the circumstances permit, you know, throw curses on a man. Because you may have a dude who comes up, you may not be a believer, and then through you constantly being persistent, he may be persuaded better yet. You know, but you have certain believers, the non-believers, scoffers, mockers, they're worthy of having curses thrown up on them. Like the dude that came out here and showed us his rod, you know, and tried to have a dick measuring contest. As soon as we left in the parking lot, we threw curses up on him, man.
Because the Lord has given us, spiritual discernment.
Yep.
You can be able to read somebody 7 senses. Yeah. Going back, yes, about 17 and 5, those 7 senses, to be able to see if someone's a bug out or someone just doesn't have the understanding.
Yep.
But they still inquire. They're still sitting there and listening to the certain things, but they might not be able to get everything in that same day.
Yep.
Just like all the brothers have certain things that were, you know, in the beginning were difficult or whatever, but now the Lord has been suffering.
2nd Esdras 14 to 47, I'm going to get 46 again. But the 70 last that thou, but keep the 70 last that thou mayest deliver them only to such as be wise among the people, those that have the spirit of understanding.
The 70 is according to a complete number of books. You see a market for it.
Yep. For in them is the spring of understanding.
the fountain of wisdom, and the stream of knowledge. Real quick, I got to get Proverbs, the 16th chapter.
Yep, the stream of knowledge.
Yep. The spring of understanding.
Yeah, then also, it speaks about the topographer as far as the brook.
Yep.
You know, you have the river and then the stream, and the Lord keeps increasing.
This is Proverbs 16, and I'll get 16, I'm going to get 21, then we'll go back to 16 and 16, I'll get 16 and 20. And it reads, how much better is it to get wisdom than gold, and to get understanding rather than to be chosen than silver? And it reads, the highway of the upright is to depart from evil. He that keepeth his way preserveth his soul. Proverbs 16 and 21, and he reads Proverbs 16 and 22. Understanding is a wellspring of life unto him that hath it, but the instruction of fools is folly.
Real quick, let me add on that. This is Sirach 24 and 31. I said, I will water my best garden, and I will water it abundantly, my garden bed, and lo, my brook became a river, and my river became a sea.
Keep on reading number 33.
I got you, brother. Yep. It says, I will yet make doctrine to shine as the morning.
Yep.
I will send forth her light afar off. I will put yet pour out doctrine as prophecy, and leave it to all the ages forever.
Yep. And that's why we're able to understand these scriptures, man. You know? It's the spirit within us, through Yahweh Bashem Yahshai, that's given us the understanding.
It speaks right here. It says 34.
I labor not for myself.
Yep. So right, because what we do, we labor for what the elect. We labor for brother to be able to, Lord willing, get the knowledge. But the Lord has to draw him out. Right? This is Sirach 24 and 34.
Beautiful.
Behold, that I have not labored for myself only,
but
for all them that seek wisdom. That's why we're out here. Okay, the Lord put us out here to what? Avenge of those fruits.
We endure all things for the elect's sake.
All the infirmities, the standing here for hours and hours, enduring what
the elements,
the heat.
Coming out here in the wintertime, getting sick, coming out in the summertime, and then your voice is hoarse,
Because it's been mad humid.
Sweating over here sometimes, but it's all good, though.
Yeah, humid. And then it says all the labor's not, Yahabashu Rasha is not giving out labor to food. Hebrews 6.
Close on out, brother.
All right, Revelation chapter 3. In verse 21, it says, to him that overcometh will I grant to sit with me in my throne, even as I also overcame and am set down with my Father in his throne.
Because your Holy Shai overcame there. That hey, y'all, grant to endure until the end, the same shall be saved. But you got to endure until the end.
He that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the church.
Understand. You got to understand and have an ear.
Yeah, because wisdom is not given to us. Bring it out one more time.
All right, it says, to him that overcometh will I grant to sit with me in my throne, even as I also overcame and am set down with my Father in his throne.
Because Yahweh Shai is on the throne, and we're praying that we're written in what, the book of life. Matthew 19, where we're able to sit.
Verse 27 and then 29.
Spoke about, if I do all these things, Lord, what will you give me?
This is Matthew.
I already broke it down.
Matthew chapter 19, verse 27. It says, then answered Peter and said unto him, behold, we have forsaken all.
We've forsaken all,
And followed.
That's a legacy that continues onto the men who are making their bodies a living sacrifice, man. You may have your boss walk by, and then you get fired the next day. You may have your girl leave you, your mom betray you. You may have your best friend snitch on you, Those are the fiery trials of your faith,
Who do you stand with?
Yep.
Who do you believe in?
Yep.
So if you stand on your Irish eye, then he's going to be able to help you out with whatever that goes on, whatever it is. He's been given all power from Yahweh, right?
Yep. And the spiritual demon Satan can't kill you if you're the elect, you know?
Because who gets the order?
Going back into Job, unless you're a martyr, Betty, you know? Going back into our forefather Job, the instruction was given unto him, you can do everything, but you can't kill him, you know? And Job lost everything, but what did he receive? Double fold, man.
And Job goes back to the elect, which means persecuted.
Yep.
Beautiful. It says, behold, we have forsaken all and followed thee. What shall we have therefore? And Yehoshua said unto him, verily I say unto you, that ye which have followed me in the regeneration, when the Son...
Reincarnation.
Regeneration.
Regeneration, reincarnation, the same thing. You're not going to be able to understand the doctrine of Yehoshua Bashim Yahshai without subscribing to reincarnation.
This ye which have followed me in the regeneration, which the Son of Man shall sit in the throne of his glory, ye shall also sit up on 12 thrones, judging the 12 tribes of Israel.
Yep, and that's what this thing, that's the end goal of this thing, man, is to be one of those men in the form of the governing body of the nation of Israel, or one of the elect, you know, because the governing body is 144,000, but if you're the innumerable multitude, that's still just some regular Jake born in the kingdom, you know? That's our desire, is to be of the elect.
To be in the book of life.
Yeah.
You know?
It says, and everyone that hath forsaken houses, or brethren, or sisters, or father, or mother, or wife, or children, or lands for my name's sake, shall receive an hundredfold, and shall inherit everlasting life.
For my name's sake, you know, going into the actual name of the Heavenly Father's only begotten Son, but actually for his rank and his, for in the coming in the stead of, you know, teaching sound doctrine, man, you know.
It says, but many that are first shall be last, and the last shall be first.
Yep, speaks for itself. So with that, we'll close on out. And in closing, we'll turn to the east and give all praise, honor, and infinite glory unto
Hashem, Yahawashai, Bahashim, Rakakadash.
Double honors to the head apostles and elders of Great Millstone, who do well and teach well with sound doctrine. Shalom unto the elders and the elder bishops of Great Millstone as well. Shalom, shalom. Peace, love, salutations, a blessing unto the hope of the elect, and the hearty shalom to the sincere brethren doing the work of truth and sincerity spread across the four winds of the earth. Shalom, shalom. And last but not least, a hearty shalom to the men of valor and DTA camps. Shalom, shalom. And so next time, next camp stream, next live stream, shalom, DTA, wa ababa. So, hey, shalom, y'all.
Hey, y'all about Shimmy on Shabbat Rakata. Hey, y'all about
Shimmy on Shabbat Rakata. Glad you made it, bro.
Oh, I know. Same here. Y'all about Shimmy on Shabbat Rakata.